Yeah, I know you're waiting. Be right back at you. 5 minutes. It's a rollout show live at Morris Media. Yeah, don't move.
Yo, we are here. We are live in the bunker off of, I won't say where because you can find us. It's the rollout show.
Look for the liquor bank.
Live from Morris Media. It's your boy Speedy.
You know what, Speedy? Somebody in the chat room said, let's make a bet and see how long it takes Speedy to remember the studio he's in.
Morris Media. Yeah, I ain't gonna fuck up. That was the problem.
And what's cool, you guys, is he has a big Morris Media sign sitting right in front of his face.
Yeah.
And
he, I ain't read that one. I'm reading this little one.
And
I
it's written on the inside of your glasses.
Right.
Look down.
It doesn't have it
right. But it's in reverse when I'm looking at it. It's your boy Speedy.
I'm the poetess.
And RT, the white boy, the most ignorant with the least pigment, is back in the building.
Yes. And we appreciate you guys who listened to us on Monday, and even though we had to deal with
Wait, we forgot Lewis.
Well, apparently.
Where's Lewis?
He can't be apparently here right now.
Apparently, he got a call from Bill Cosby.
He's been sequestered.
Yeah. So whatever he going to talk about, going to be like, no, yeah, no, yeah. That's all he can say is no, yeah, no, yeah.
Yeah,
he apparently, can't say shit else.
Apparently, he had a dinner meeting, and Cosby was like, here, drink this. We need to talk.
I'm sleepy. Yeah, now let's talk. Why is it hot in here? I don't know what that pill do to you. Apparently, it make you take your shit off.
Yeah. Apparently, it makes you get
apparently, you can. You know you getting fucked, but you can't do shit about it. All you know, you bent over. Why is he in my ass? This is and I can't stop him.
That's not a pudding pop.
What kind of joke is that?
Hey, yeah. That's a punchline in my ass.
I think Lewis is coming. I don't know.
Hey, I wouldn't come. My best friend was involved in some bullshit like that.
Is Bill really Lewis's best friend?
No.
Not at all.
Not at all.
Lou who?
Dicks. No. Fuck with dicks.
Oh, there was the one time I tried to bang your wife. Oh.
She didn't drink the medicine.
I gave her a little bit of the hot tea. Oh, read her a bedtime story, you see.
And we're not saying Bill did anything. Well, it's 30 women
he
that said
he
that.
Did.
He said he did.
Oh, Bill said he did?
Yeah, you can't get more guilty than he was like, because he said in the, what happened was there was a civil case, I guess, where he had to settle.
10 years ago,
10 years ago, where he had to settle with a woman.
How much?
It didn't say.
Yeah, it was undisclosed, but you know it was a lot. If Bill was
a couple mil tickets, I'm sure
put through the ringer like that. So he admitted that. Yeah, I buy drugs to give to women to get them messed up so I can get in their pants.
Yeah.
And here's the thing, dudes have been doing. I mean, that's part of our game is getting.
No.
I'm not saying pills.
No.
We try to get women inebriated. Yes, I do. I try to get women.
You're white.
Inebriated.
You try to get.
No, but I've never given a woman a pill. That's like you circumventing the route. Like you just saying, go to sleep, bitch, and I'm gonna fuck you. That's what kind of shit.
See,
is that?
I don't even like a woman drunk. I feel like if she drunk, she don't know I fuck. And I don't want her to be like, what's your name again?
I feel like when they drunk, they make bad decisions, and that's good for me.
Nah, I can't do it. I want to know a motherfucker is sober and getting his dick. I don't want no bitch going, so what's your name?
You want them to know they're making a terrible mistake.
Yes. I want them to know. I did fuck Speedy and I wasn't drunk.
It was a horror show.
Well, I have to admit, after a couple of drinks, you guys do look better.
Ain't that a bitch?
See, that's what I'm talking about.
Well, drink your coffee then.
Yeah, Denzel Washington over here. Bradley Cooper over here. You good.
Have you ever gotten that drunk? To make a bat like, did I really fuck you?
Nah.
Mm-mm. You ever come close? Like, the dick come out, you go, I'm good. Because poet is, you know I love, because she real. She probably went, if you don't put your dick back up.
Yeah.
If you ever had a woman tell you, you'll put my dick back up? My bad. Gonna zip this shit up.
Yeah, that's always a weird. That's always a weird incident where you pull your dick out prematurely. And you're like, hey, surprise!
And like, we not fucking.
Oh, whoops. This is not the bathroom. I'll pee somewhere else, I guess.
One time, I went over to a guy that I had just recently started dating. It was the first time I ever went over his house. It was probably like our second date or whatever. And, you know, I'm sitting in the living room. He goes, hey, come back here to the room.
Let's Let's talk about stuff in my bed.
I come in here, he is going there, and he is butt ass naked. Like, I was like, wow, for real.
Standing there like a naked Captain Morgan.
And then you went.
I was like, I'm gonna be in the living room. Nervy. Nah, I just looked at him. I wanted to laugh because I thought it was so nervy.
No, don't laugh with a motherfucker naked. That ain't there's no recovery from that. No, I'm just playing. Yeah. You just playing, bitch. I was naked.
Is this a fifth floor apartment? I'm jumping out the window.
I like in Seinfeld when old boy got naked.
Oh, but, the shrinkage.
And it shrunk. And he's like, no, I just got out the pool. The bitch was like, anyway.
Yeah, George is like, no, explain the shrinkage. It does shrink.
So I was just in the pool. So what did y'all do? Did you?
Nah, I didn't do it that night.
So did he get, how do you get redressed?
I went back in the living room.
Oh!
Yeah. I would do something more entertaining.
I was
only on
second. I wasn't, you know.
So he walked in with, you want some water or something?
Yeah. Well, I put my clothes back on, I guess.
I guess I'm going to slip this robe on.
Potus was like, I'm going to go in the kitchen and make a Hot Pocket. While you play with your strudel over there.
Now, I had this one girl came over, and she got into bed. I'm naked. When you're in my bed... I got my midriff shirt on.
Your midriff shirt?
I always wear a midriff.
What?
I let the dick hang.
Oh, let me God.
See, see that? Ugh. You can't see the stomach, but you see the dick.
I don't need that visual.
So I got my midriff on, and she get naked and went, we ain't doing nothing. I went, well, you finna get some baby batter on your back. I know that goddamn much.
I want you to know I jack off in my sleep. I just, as long as you know that, we can sleep together. We're good.
As soon as I bust, I da-da-da, da-da-da, now we go to sleep.
Oh, hey, who ordered the hot breakfast?
Put that in your coffee.
Oh, my God. I want to shout out to everybody that's listening right now. You're listening to the new rollout show at Morris Media Studios.
You told me live from Morris Media.
Live.
That's what I wrote.
Use your finger, Speedy.
Live. That's live from.
Oh, okay. Live from. Let me read it right then. The rollout show, live from Morris Media.
Call us up 323-293-3375.
Yeah, talk about whatever.
We're just getting started. Still ironing out the kinks up here, so bear with us.
But so is that what happened with Lou? Like Cosby's people hit him up?
Yeah,
said you
that's
can't
what
talk
he told me. I called him. He goes, did you post that I was going to talk about Cosby today? Yeah.
Uh oh, they called him.
The Cosby cops.
Yeah. Pull over. It's the police.
They pulled him over on his way over there. So he said he's coming.
I'm hoping. Well, if Bill said he did it, he did it. So now
well, you know, 40 women right. came out and said he did it. So, I mean, I don't know if all of them are true or some are just opportunists. Come on.
The funny thing is, I feel like there's actually like a lack of a backlash now that he admitted it. People are like, yeah, we see now. Whereas before, everybody was like, he's a rapist. And then now everybody's kind of like, oh, yeah, well, he was just kind of drugging him. You know, I feel like that's the vibe I got.
It was cool with it, I guess.
Yeah, I guess they wanted it.
Here's my thing. If 40 people say you did it,
oh,
you probably did.
You did it.
Now, one motherfucker said I did some shit and fucked my whole life up. So if 40 motherfuckers can't get your shit fucked up.
Yeah, it's hard to get your back. Like if one or two, if you're like, look, a couple people are saying I did something, you might be like, but 40?
40 motherfuckers.
That's a guilty verdict.
Over 40? 40 people.
And then I know a question would be, well, why did he do it like that? I mean, I think it's
because some people, that's how they
that's
get
his,
that.
Yeah.
And that's your get that.
That's his thing. He likes an unresponsive woman. That's room temperature. I don't know.
I don't know. We have a phone call.
Pick your arm up, let it drop. Boom. I got you.
If it's Bill Cosby's lawyer, we're not here.
Yeah. We have a call. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Yo, what's up? This is Michelle from Detroit, OG.
Hi, Michelle.
What's up, hey, Michelle?
There's other people in the room, Michelle.
I didn't know this was a personal phone call.
Hold on, Chunky Butt. I was getting around.
Uh-huh. Would you call him Chunky Butt?
Yes.
Not no more.
Chunky Butt. I do the Chunky Butt.
How you doing,
Hi,
beautiful?
Hi, Speed. I'm how you doing? Well. How are you? Hey, RT.
Hi, how are you? What's happening?
I'm good. I'm just in Detroit representing right quick. It's so good to hear y'all back on the air, though.
Thank you, baby. It's good to hear you. Where you on your way to?
I'm not on my way anywhere. I'm at work right now, just Ooh. Walking around on my lunch break.
Where you work at?
Wait, there are jobs in Detroit?
thought they was all.
Slow down, dirty fool.
I thought they was all in Japan. Yeah, man.
Well, they shipped them out.
Shout out to Barack. No. Barack did it.
No, I work in healthcare, so I always have it.
Oh, there you go.
So, how are you listening to us right now?
Right now, I'm listening to you guys on Ustream.
On your mobile?
On my phone. Yep, on my phone.
Shout out to cell phones.
There we go.
Right.
We love you, Michelle. Thanks for all your support. Yeah. Rolling with us all the time. We
and buy a t-shirt. Yeah.
Don't you? I will punch you calling my girl that.
That's what I have to say. In the, it says, buy a t-shirt, bitch, no matter who on the phone.
Exactly. Exactly. Right. But no, I definitely will continue to support you guys as long as y'all keep putting out that good shit. So I bought more than my fair share of fucking t-shirts so I can make a damn.
We got to sell something else, Speedy. Let's sell some coffee mugs.
Right.
Buy a coffee mug, bitch.
Wake up. Wake up.
Thank you for the phone call, baby girl.
Thank you, Michelle.
He said, is there jobs in Detroit?
Shout out to everybody in the Radio Freaks VIP page and the Team Outcast and the unofficial Speedy page, the Good Times page, the Boxhole page.
And don't forget,
we got about 100 spinoffs.
Apparently so.
I want a page now.
We're still doing the Palm Springs, just in case anybody was wondering. We are still going to be in Palm Springs next week. If you already signed up to go, you're going to have a great time. We will be live by the pool doing the show. And we have the comedy show that Thursday, so it's going to be hot. Poet is going to be there. Benny's out. You wearing a two-piece or one-piece? You look like a two-piece. I'm just letting you know. You look sexy right now.
One-piece.
Damn it.
One piece.
Look, he just has
a dress.
One piece dress.
A nightie. A nightgown.
Look in the pool. Is that a nightie? She got a stuffed bear in the pool.
She has a tail. You know, she has a trailer.
When I went
pool.
With you guys the year before last, I really had a good time.
Yeah, it was fun.
Good look.
Yeah.
We have another phone call.
Yeah, it was fun.
Yeah, it was.
We have a great time this time. So again, we will be in Palm Springs. DJ Twin will
what
be spinning.
Dates?
That's Friday or Thursday. July 19th.
It's one of 365 days.
It's next Thursday. Let's put it that way. However, whenever Thursday fall on.
Whatever those numbers are.
Thursday to Sunday.
Coordinate with next Thursday.
I'll be there.
16, man.
Hey, watch your tone.
There it is. Thank you, DJ.
There's a reason you don't have a microphone.
DJ Twin will be there, and Speedy's doing the comedy show on Thursday.
He does have a mic.
And then we'll do the radio show by the pool. Okay. I have all the t-shirts and hoodies. I don't know why I'm selling hoodies in
Palm
Springs.
Them
in the summer.
Yeah. We have a call.
They on sale.
What's your name and where you calling from?
This is John calling from Mississippi.
Hey, John from Mississippi.
I'm from Mississippi.
Yeah, man. Hey, look, I'm one of your biggest fans, Speedy.
Thank you, brother.
Speedy.
Literally.
Sound like you're in a truck right now, baby.
Look, man, I'm so glad to see the show again. I finally got my phone to work right. Check it out.
Call waiting.
Oh, somebody else is calling you.
Yeah, I've been enjoying it, bro.
Thank you, bro. Where are you on your way to now?
Man, I'm just out here working, trying to stay cool for a minute, but I'm going to take a long lunch break and check y'all out.
Yeah, it's hot down there in Mississippi, huh?
Don't get fired now, because we can't help you with the unemployment.
Although I heard there are jobs in Detroit in the healthcare field, so if you want to check that out.
Well, Speedy definitely knows about that, then.
Watch your tone. Watch your tone and delivery there, boy. I come down to M-I-S-S-I-S-P-P-I.
You spell that right, Speedy. Holy shit.
I thought I missed the I.
Maybe you did. That was early.
Damn, love y'all guys, and I'll be in touch.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, man, for real.
Appreciate the phone. Again, the phone call is 323-293-3375. If you got a flip phone, don't try to look at us on the flip phone, man.
You can hear us, though.
You can hear us. You just can't see shit on the flip phone.
Don't try to call us on CB. Breaker 19, I'm calling the radio
show. You know, I got one of them free phones. You know, they be sitting out in front of the 99 cent store. It's the weirdest shit. You want a free phone? Everybody goes, no, nigga, because you think it's I said, let me see. And, nigga, Barack hooked me up again.
With a free 99 cent phone?
I got, apparently because I have Obamacare.
AARP?
No, ain't that a bitch?
Triple AARP.
Them phones too big. They got the big ass number. It's a big one.
Hello?
Big two.
Yeah, they cans like the old school one. Hello?
Hello?
Two individual.
No, but I have Obamacare. So I got free healthcare.
Oh, is that what
damn, that's the
and
shit
went wrong. As soon as I got it, I
you're healthy.
As an ox right now.
Young whippersnapper.
Yeah, ain't got
we
shit
have another call.
Who's on the phone? This your boy Speedy. Who's this?
This is
Hey, what's going on, Speedy? This is Lou Dix's best friend calling in.
Hi, Lou Dix's best friend.
What's up, Lou Fritz?
I didn't know Lewis had any friends.
He don't, but apparently somebody's crawled out.
Yeah, when you have one friend, it's the best friend.
Yeah, I'm his number one fan. I got the t-shirts coming up for sale, so get them Lou Dix's best friends.
What does the t-shirt say on the front?
That's a picture of Lou Dix from his heyday with an arrow pointing up saying I'm Lou Dix's best friend.
Hilarious!
He's my best friend.
Oh my God.
He's had
I want one. I am Lewis's friend, though.
No, but you got his best friend, though.
You got the best friend. In capitals, your best.
You're a friend.
You got them shirts. They $12.99.
Okay.
$12.99.
And that's shipping and handling?
No, no, not shipping and handling.
That's extra.
They'll be on the website pretty soon. LewDixBestFriend.com.
He don't have one.
That's on another line.
Yeah, it's on MySpace.
You can find him on MySpace.
Yeah. Got all the greatest hits from Showtime at the Apollo. Hanging with Mr. Cooper warm up.
He is Louis' best friend. He know all this
got
shit.
All of,
yeah. Hanging with Mr. Cooper
warm up. And what's that website again?
www.LewDixBestFriend.com
And don't forget to put the arrow in there.
He's my best friend.
Still got to put the www on there. That's how long
I put. Yeah, six W's. Yeah, Lewis has extra W's.
People, let me tell
two
you.
Two of them are his mustache.
It's me, Peanut, Fat Paul, and Boogie in it.
Even those Lewis's childhood friends.
It's a weird looking friend.
LewisDixBestFriends.com.
All right. Appreciate the phone call.
Thank you, man.
People, let me tell you about my best friend.
Good to know Lewis has a friend. That's good.
I love that show.
That's good that he has a friend.
Anyway, Lou not coming. He's too scared.
The lawyers called him off.
The ridicule of his supposedly other friend, Bill Cosby. Mm. And if you believe Bill did it, call in. If you don't believe it, call in anyway.
I mean, what's not to believe once you admit that you did something?
How old is Bill?
Old enough to know better. Fuck.
In his 70s, I think.
So now you really got to give bitches the pill because you 70 yeah. with the gray beard.
Yeah. Now, the gray question is, even if he admits to everything, there's really is a statute of limitations are up. So there's really nothing
that
can happen to him other than financially, you know, all his endorsements, all his deals.
Unless he murdered the pussy, then he then he could go on trial.
Well, he can't go on the road. He can't, like, he's on the road now, and he can't go on the road. We got another phone call.
Yeah, yeah, he's screwed. He can't do anything. They cancel all the shows. Yeah.
Turn your house down.
Yeah, turn your house down, bro. It's a
hold on.
Okay. Hey, who's this?
It's Pam.
Hey, which
Nikki
Pam?
Pam.
Oh, Pam.
Nikki shit. Pam, nigga.
Bitch, ain't supposed to be here. How you on the phone?
I'm coming because I was watching the show while I was driving. I was getting an accident from laughing.
Oh, my God.
Don't get wrecked.
It looks really good. You guys got the number at the bottom. I had never seen it. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, it looks great, you guys.
Well, we actually paid Rock today. We didn't pay him on money. When you don't pay a motherfucker, they kind of work a little bit.
I was late because I was trying to get some dig, but I had to
Digging the board.
Oh, Lord.
Dang. So I'll be there in a minute.
Okay. Dick in the morning.
Guys.
Wake up.
Try to get that morning wood.
Oh, right.
Wake up.
Yeah.
That's the best sex, isn't it?
Yeah. Especially when she's coming over. Because you just like, hello. I'm going to come through. Cool. I'm up.
I showered.
That's when you go to the bathroom, the gargle, everything. And then she don't show up. Bitch, I'm brush my teeth.
Yeah. Morning sex is good. That means you made the cut.
Because she made five other calls. Trust me. You were sick.
That means you're still hanging out from last night. That's good.
Yeah. All right, Pam. We'll see you in a minute.
Okay, bye.
Morning.
Right. Don't get into a wreck, Pam. Mm.
I can't. Because I know you so well. People, y'all don't know how well I know Porter. I can't see you calling a nigga in the morning going, I'm going to come through and get
no,
that.
No, he would already be in my...
No, but would you call somebody to go get it before you come to work?
In the morning, I'm on work business. See? But if you're already here...
Yeah, if you're already laying down.
Yeah, if you're already there,
now, you hook a brother up while you sleep?
Nigga, I'm not finna go back to all that.
That was a yes.
Yes, a yes. You didn't say no. Normally
and I didn't
like,
say yes.
You don't have
so,
to.
So POTUS is the reverse Bill Cosby. She's putting dudes to sleep.
Shut up.
Just let me go to work out here for a minute.
You shut the fuck up, I'll hook you up.
Sweet dreams, darling.
Oh, you ever talk yourself out some pussy?
Oh, geez, that's the worst.
Hey, anyway.
Because y'all can say one dumb thing and just ruin the whole
thing. And they always end with,
Sid.
I knew it was over when I was running a game, and, my game was tight. I was at the bar. I was like, man, I'm getting this pussy. And like, my friend was a bartender, and I had a couple other friends there. They're like, you're in there, giving me the thumbs up, right? And then I said, I don't know what I did, but I said something wrong. Next thing I know, she was gone. I was holding the purse. I was like, oh, it's over.
She like
shit.
Really went home?
No. She just
she
went out.
She was in her purse.
You know, she went to go talk to somebody else. I was like, well, that's it for me. I was like,
that's why I don't buy drinks at clubs.
I was like, what did I do?
That's why you don't buy drinks at clubs.
No. You ain't finna be walking around with my drink drunk and somebody else.
I know,
succeed.
Somebody else get it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I said him.
That's
up.
How
what
you
the?
Men really think, huh?
Ooh. You drink with
you,
me.
You're not
you
just being
drink,
nice with- by buying a drink. You done dance with me. 15 minutes, I'm sweating, I'm thirsty. And
oh, yeah.
I'll buy you a drink, bitch, you my date.
Yeah, don't think that this is just a charity evening for you that you get free shit. No.
As soon as you try to walk away with another nigga, what's happening, homie? I already bought a drink. Nigga,
yeah.
So,
yeah, they're prerequisites. Yeah. You at least have to talk until the drink is finished. So you can chug it if you want. But
this bitch stumbles, she with me. The minute she stumbled, it's my bitch.
And I tell you what's funny, they're killing Cosby on the memes. You seen the Morpheus meme?
Oh, yeah.
Where, the red pill or the blue pill. I'm like, they're killing him.
Bill, call in. Yeah, Bill, the number is 323-293-3375.
Yeah.
Call in, let us know yourself.
This is the Cosby Show.
I don't think nobody care anymore, though. I think this would have been, if his show would have been out and you told me this.
But it came, this whole story, what, came out about a year ago?
Yeah, because Hannibal Buress did the stand-up set where he said Google Bill Cosby.
And he actually does say it in the set.
Yeah.
Well, it's been all over the news. But like I said, I think the only repercussions he's going to face is financial. I mean, because by law, I mean, can you put criminal charges on
him? No, all that can be done is a civil suit to say, give me some money, you sexually assaulted me. And if he admitted in 2005, there's a good chance that they're going to get him to admit that he did it again. So I'd expect a lot of lawsuits. If it's 40 women, he's going to get a lot of lawsuits.
Each one of them only won $10
million. Oh. Mm. I heard they took a statue down at Disneyland.
Yeah.
He had a statue at Disneyland?
And they stopped running all the reruns of the Cosby
Show. Wait a minute. He had a statue at Disneyland?
I didn't know that either.
Yeah. Yeah, he had like a bronze.
Was it in Sleepyville?
Yeah. It was in Pilltown.
Pilltown.
Happy Pilltown.
If you just tuned in, you're listening to the all-new Rollout Show live from Morris Media.
Yes.
See how smooth
and we're going to take a quick break and come back with some
for
weird
what?
News, shit that's going on in the headlines right now. That's crazy. So it's 323.
Outside of Bill Cosby.
293-3375, and we'll be right back.
Yeah.
RT the white boy.
And joining us here at the round table is
Nikki Pam.
Located in a bunker.
Yes.
Used to be at a lair. We got,
so fools won't bomb on us.
Yeah, but it's still so nice.
Not the lair, but now I'm in the bunker. But anyway, it's a Rollout Show. And it's now time for
Weird Things Happening
on a Wednesday.
On a Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Let me
up
put
until
on
Wednesday.
My
spectacles. Get your glasses. I got mine. I don't need to put them on till it's time to read.
Your bifocals. I got on my trifocals.
It's so funny. We all have glasses. Well,
here's the thing.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah.
No, it's coming. Yeah. Trust me,
it definitely is coming.
Definitely coming.
Hey, I went to get my driver's license renewed like last year, and for the first time in my life, when they tell you to read the letters, my whole life I've been like, psh, E-I-B-G. I don't even have to look at the motherfucker. I look at this one, I'm like, hold on. Like, let me get focused. I had to act like I wasn't focusing in front of the guy. I was like,
CB.
No, you know what? That's funny you say that, RT, because I had to renew my license this year, and they said I had to take the
driver's test.
The driver's, the actual, the written, you know, the written test and the eye test. So I was like, oh, shit.
Can you see? Did you have a ticket
up there? Can I get closer, right in front
expired.
Of it?
Oh, okay.
And I'm sitting there the whole time. I'm not even worried about flunking a written test.
Right.
I studied.
Yeah, shit written on your hand.
I cannot smoke weed while I drive. No. I cannot.
So I'm sitting there looking at the graph. I'm trying to memorize, trying to do, because I was like, I cannot see. I'm
F follows D, D follows Y, Y follows M. Got it.
But I went up there and knocked it out. I was like, cool, because I just knew that.
Nigga.
Ma'am, you're reading the anti-pregnancy poster for teens?
I did like this. I said, bitch, this. I put my hand on. That's small print. He said, not at the top. I'm like, oh, shit.
Oh,
said, sir, put your glasses on. All right, my bad.
Read these letters. Those are letters?
I was trying to read a sentence. And James said, bitch looks at the cat. She said, James?
What do you see?
That's what it reads to me. It says, James says, oh, that's Jim Jam Jam.
Those aren't words. They're just letters.
Jim Jam Jam. Yeah. All right, weird news. What you got for me, baby?
Okay, if you're looking to make a quick $10,000, a banker is offering $10,000 to anybody who can set him up on a date.
I saw that. I
and the date turns into a relationship that lasts at least 6 months.
Pam, I need
I'm
you.
I'm with it.
We need I'm you, with Pam.
It. Well, if you think about it, 6 months some money. Divided by 10 grand, I'll give you $2,000.
Let me read the story. Let me read it. A banker is offering $5,000 to anybody that want to date him, Pam.
Wow.
You get a cut.
You get a cut.
Now, don't think of me as a pimp. Think of me as your relationship advisor.
He can't be horrific looking or anything.
Well, he's actually an Asian man. His name is Ren Lu Yu.
Never mind.
Okay. Oh, he's an Asian man. What's
his name? Ren Lu Yu.
Ren Yu.
Oh, he's Asian.
Ren Lu Yu. He's 29.
Well, hold it right there.
All right.
I'm sorry.
So you got to walk into Smike.
Pam said, that's all right.
You got to walk into
say that.
You got to do like this. Who's this? Fuck, this is the motherfucker's name. This Ren Lu.
Ren Lu Kim.
This is an Asian nigga I'm fucking right now for some money. Lies gonna break down.
That's his name.
He's 29. He's from Birmingham, Alabama,
He has
a website set up for anybody who wants to try to hook him up. It's dateren.com. You have to submit a photo.
I'm good.
Measurements.
I was out at Asian.
Come on, you
information.
Pam,
pretend he's MC Ren. You can get with him.
It does say dateren.com.
Okay.
Now, I'll give you a story.
Uh-oh.
So, one of my friends is dating a Japanese girl.
Oh, wow.
And she bought him. She came from Japan. She was dating. She's married, got divorced, got all his money, live up in Hollywood Hills. She bought him one of them, the Porsche Cayenne or Cheyenne or whatever
it is. Cheyenne.
Whatever Cayenne. It is. It's Cayenne.
A Cayenne. Pepper.
Uh-huh. So, I was like, what? He said, yeah, but she got a friend. I'm like, all right, cool. Introduce me. I'll get me one. Right. I got the gift of gab.
Yeah, you do.
He introduced me to the girl, and I go sit down at the little booth, and I'm like, hey, how you doing? Don't speak no English. I'm like, oh, shit. My game ain't going to work, bitch. You
right, right.
English. So I said, well,
just pull out your dick.
I'm trying to get the call. So I said, well, you know, maybe we can hang out. You come to my comedy show. No, I don't see ya. No. Speaker, no. Now I'm getting frustrated, like, okay, bitch. Let me show you what I'm working with, man.
What do you mean you don't understand the lies I'm telling you?
I'm trying to lie to you, bitch.
Either you get it or you don't. God damn it.
I couldn't do it. She didn't speak no
English. It was tough. No English.
She didn't nothing. So
really?
I mean, come on. My gift is
you
what I can say.
You couldn't even hit?
Nah. Because I had just met her, and we were sitting in the booth at a club. And so I'm trying to go, so you
know. Yeah, if you can't even communicate a little.
Because normally I'd like this. Ready, Pam? It goes like this. So how you doing?
Good.
Cool. You look cute. I haven't seen you in a while. You come here often?
Oh, God. You know, I try. Right, but cool. I've never seen you here.
Well, you know, I'm doing stand-up. I'm going up in a few minutes.
Oh.
Mr. Caldwell, your tab is due. Your tab. your credit card is no good.
Declined.
Do you have cash? It's declined. Do you have cash, sir?
So your name is Pam?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Can you get this round? I'm going to get the next one.
No.
Does that work for you?
Way.
Seriously,
man,
no way.
Back in the day before I got murdered, I was that nigga. I was so good. I had a white girl give me money in front of her daughter.
Are you? And you're proud of that?
Yes. Nigga, this dick got to get paid.
He made it. It's success.
I got
to. That is nothing to be proud of. Speedy.
Trust me, I didn't want to take it like that. She gave it to me. I was like,
I'll take it.
I'm sure I didn't want to take it like that. Yeah, okay, Speedy, we believe that.
Hey, man, if the dick good, you'll pay for it, right, Pam? Thank you. Let's move on.
Pam has paid
for some good dick.
Cordis just said hell no. You have never, ever paid for dick. I mean, not pay like, oh, if you fuck me, you know, here's money. But like a dinner or.
I've treated.
Okay.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I hit you like this.
I just nailed it. You sleep. You knocked out. And I go, damn. And you go, what's wrong, baby? Fucking RT booked this show and I didn't get paid for the shit. And then you say, oh, wow, do you need some money? I say, nah, I'm good. But
and
thank
then
you.
I say, okay.
No.
And you go, fine, like, I'll
okay,
take
cool.
it.
No, only if you're my dude.
That's what I'm saying. It don't matter. Trust me,
if
I got it like
my
that.
Dude.
I had it like that. Just listen.
Yeah, but
so
not
you'll
some
say,
random
yeah,
nigga.
Yeah.
I'm fucking,
yeah.
no.
You would say, nah, I'm cool. And then I would say, don't. Then you go, you sure you don't need it? I mean, if you got it.
I'm not gonna lie.
As I'm inserting.
That has happened to me.
See what I'm saying?
I'm not gonna lie. I got that once or twice.
Pam broke. She would be at. I had a
damn,
girl.
Have no more.
I had a woman when I was 25. She was 50. She gave me her PIN number. I couldn't believe it. Nigga,
It was three.
She said, well, because before I would ask her for some money, she's like, oh, here, this is PIN number. If you need it, just go get it. I'm like, all right, so. I make sure I hit, and then I left. And I'm right. like, I got to see if this shit works. I went up to the thing. I said, 4475.
So are you a male prostitute?
Hold on. And that motherfucker said, how much you want?
What's the max?
The problem with her
take
old ass.
5,000.
With her old ass, it came out
the limit is 300.
It came out as Confederate dollars. You have some old ass money.
Hey,
what is this gold doubloon?
At the end of my day, I got that thing. I got that thing. Trust me. You'd have been part of the get down.
No, I would not.
Yes,
have.
You would have. You
That's
would've,
why
you
I dated Jamie
no
instead of you.
Whoa!
Shots fired.
In your face.
Damn.
You'd be Speedy be sitting there mad as hell.
Boy, this you just don't know. I'm telling you, I was good. I was borderline great.
Was, but it's over now.
Yeah, it's over. you ain't shit now, Wilkie. Now it's just like.
Do you use the blue pill now?
No. I got an imagination.
Mm. Or the red pill.
So what kind of things do you imagine, Speedy? Mm-hmm. I hate to ask.
What are you into, Speedy?
Now I'm back here with you.
The blue pill is fiber, by the way. Take some fiber.
Yeah, please. But I saw that story. I was like, well, you. Here's my thing, though. Why would a woman just not hit him up if she wants to date him? Why does he have to get somebody to hook him up?
Well,
actually, he had been on 30 dates during the last 10 months, and they all failed to result in a happy relationship.
And he's a millionaire?
He didn't say he's a millionaire, but obviously he has some money if he's...
Maybe it's him.
He's private equity.
No, it's him.
Associate.
You've been on 30 dates and you ain't land one bad bill?
All right.
Yeah, I think psychologically he has a great wall up. I think that's what it is.
Moving on to the next story.
So you're saying he keep chopping up his relationships?
Hilarious. Moving on to the next story. A man named Bacon was arrested for attacking a man for eating the last piece of sausage.
Wait, what? Why, first off,
I don't believe that story.
Why is
a New Jersey man whose name...
Wait, is New Jersey?
He's from New Jersey.
A lot of weird shit.
Thomas Bacon. His name is Thomas Bacon.
Oh, it's a family name.
Yes.
From a long line of Bacons.
Right.
Fuck you and your pig mama.
He allegedly attacked another person for eating the last piece of sausage. And he was charged with simple assault.
We have to stop this pork on pork violence. We really do. We got to find our way out of this.
You know what that is. You go to the, what's the place where they have the food all out?
Oh, the buffets?
Buffet.
And you get there and you like the next dude in my bed.
He takes it all.
In your mind, you go, don't take. And that motherfucker take like 9 of them. You're like, motherfucker.
And I do that with the crab legs. I get so pissed off. I'm like, why you got to take 10?
And then they look back at you. Did you want some? No, nigga.
Right, now yeah, I gotta
I'm just,
wait.
Yeah, I'm just behind you.
I gotta
you
wait for the rest of the world.
And then you wait, and then the fat lady go, give me 4 minutes. It's like cooking. Bitch.
Oh, God, sweet.
What's that shit? What's it called? They have them down south.
There's a couple. Well, there's
I'm like,
Golden Corral. There's, yeah, hometown.
Golden Corral.
Golden Corral.
Oh, yeah.
Have you been to Golden Corral?
Yes, I have.
I lost my motherfucking mind.
Yeah, I love that place.
They don't have it in L.A. I lost the bet. I was in
Sir, you have to pay again for dinner. You can't just sit here all day.
It's like three different sections.
Yeah. Oh, it's like that hotel buffet. Yeah. Even hotel here?
It's breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
I was like, the lady said, you're going to need another platter. I was like, bitch, just pile it on top. Put the bacon on top of the chicken, on top of the lunch meat, near the sandwich bread. Bitch, just put it on there. I lost my mind at the Corral.
I bet you did. Was, all
was
you
that your
eat
first out. Buffet or something?
No, it's just I had never been to a Golden Corral.
Sir, you're not supposed to bathe in the barbecue sauce.
Then I went there in the morning for the breakfast. What the fuck are
you? You mean you had a sleepover? You had a sleepover at Golden Corral?
I went for dinner, and my dumb ass don't. I said, do y'all do breakfast? She said, yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. We do breakfast. We do lunch. You going to come back. The breakfast is fucking beautiful.
And Speedy sleeping in his car again out in front of the Golden Corral.
I had pulled the car up to the window. I said, bitch, I know when you open.
I know exactly. And don't hold those crab legs hostage.
Shout out to Golden Corral. If you work there, call in. 323-29.
I had a job one time where I had to call all the Golden Corrals. I had to call all the Golden Corrals and find out where they were on a map.
You are a telemarketer?
Uh-uh. Well, yeah, it was like a marketing job.
Oh, okay.
And so the funny thing is, a lot of Golden Corrals are in the middle of fucking nowhere.
Yes, they are.
So they were explaining to me how to get there. Like, I had to find out where exactly how to get there. So they'd say, well, you take a left by the old oak tree, then you go past the chicken farm. I'm like, where is this place? It's in the middle of Oklahoma somewhere. like 200 and something Golden Corrals. There's a ton of them.
Yeah. Next story, a man tries to rob a bank with a vibrator.
Freeze.
I'ma fuck you. That's what I'm gonna do. You don't give me my money.
It says a bomb squad blew up a briefcase and other suspicious items in a Pittsburgh
man. What, butt plug?
I think we just blew up a butt plug.
the freaky bank robber.
We spent a lot of money to blow up this motherfucking butt plug.
So wait, how did he?
He went in. They say he faces 9 felony counts.
Oh yeah, you're still going to jail.
Aggravated assault, robbery, threatening to use a weapon of mass destruction.
Ass destruction.
And the usual charge of possessing a facsimile weapon, a fake weapon of mass destruction.
Hold on.
The usual charge.
Hold on. I'm glad you read that shit. I saw that word. I went. No, you gonna read that story. I got right there. Where's it at?
Facsimile.
He had some shit with it. it's facsimile?
The weapon of mass destruction was the vibrator.
No way.
What? What kind of vibrator? Got batteries in it? motherfucker, D!
All the vibrators I've seen is the little rabbit ones that you just place on.
They have all kinds, honey.
They have all kinds.
I wish you'd have robbed you. You'd have been at the bank teller going, you don't really need the vibrator.
They have the ones now that sync up to your iPad or your music or your iTunes or whatever.
Oh, hold the fuck up. Yep. They do what?
I have one of those.
Apparently you do. You're trying to fuck in the morning.
I tried it, y'all.
Don't they have ones that could be remote controlled from somebody somewhere else?
Yeah. That's nothing.
That's the new shit. What
well,
it is
panties.
Is,
they're panties like that.
Well, no, that too, but there's you buy let's say you're dating somebody living in Chicago. So you buy them the vibrator on that end. You got the thing on your end and you maneuver it and she...
See, Pam would like rob that. The bank differently. She'd be like, I'm going to fuck myself again with this vibrator if you don't give up the cash. I will fuck myself again.
I'm going to bend over on this counter where y'all sign the checks. I'm telling you right now.
We're going to be here all day. Who has more batteries? I'll do it.
Use vibrator?
Don't ask me that. What? It's none of your business.
You know Porter's not going to talk about that.
What the fuck?
No,
you use
she's...
vibrator, Speedy?
Why would I need it?
She's going...
I mean, you can use it with her.
Back in the day, I had a woman that wanted me to put the ring. Mm-hmm. It felt weird.
The cock ring. Those are my favorite.
I like it, but not the one that turned on. Because she did like this.
I'm
cock
ring.
I put it on.
How big is your clit?
I didn't lose mine. Just saying.
I put a cock ring on my clit. Sits down there perfect.
Pam, that's a dick. I'm just saying. Put one on your clit. That's the thing. Anyway,
she didn't say she put it on her. Okay.
So the girl, like that. So the girl puts the cock ring on, and I don't know. It got a little switch. You gotta turn them up. She said, "Turn it on." I said, "Turn one on." It's so I pulled my dick and hit the little button. I'm like, "Oh
Jesus!
Is this for me or you, bitch?" Because right now I'm
it's
coming.
Us.
Yeah, I'm done.
Because two strokes. I said, "That's it, bitch." Turn his battery off. You don't want a limp dick and it's still humming. That's not a good look right there.
Thanks for that. I'm sleepy now. I'm going to bed. That was great for
my
me.
My dick was leaned to the side. It was still moving. I was like, that's not a good look for me right now. That's...
His dick was having convulsions.
And then you got to roll it off cute. I don't know how you roll a... Because I couldn't turn the thing off.
No, it's not cute.
Clear! The dick's having seizures. Clear!
I swear, I am not making this shit up. So I forgot I put the shit in my bag, and I'm going out of town.
Oh, no.
And it's going off in a thing. And the lady said, "Sir, do you have something going off in your bag?" Nah, bitch. Fuck is you talking about? Now y'all go with the shit. See, y'all just fucking with a black man. They came out, the bitch had the rubber glove on. What is this?
Don't smell it. Whatever you do, don't smell it.
I said, I couldn't turn it off. Can you turn that off?
So what is this? You don't want to know.
It was still going.
Don't touch that.
Yeah. And the lady behind me went, "I have seen it all." I said, "Well, hey, bitch."
You're like, sorry.
I forgot I put it in.
Well, I travel with the, it's a one from Bedroom Candy, and it's a little lipstick thing. And
pull your mic closer, Pam.
No, he said don't.
Oh,
see, y'all get me in trouble here.
I'm like, Rock came over and said, like, "Leave the motherfucking mic alone."
Move it, Pam. I was like, okay.
Okay.
So it's just a little lipstick vibrator?
Yeah, it's a lipstick vibrator, and it, oh, shit. Sorry about that.
It's your vibrator calling. You haven't used it this morning.
I'm in your purse.
It looks like a lipstick or whatever, you know what I'm saying, or a bullet a little bit, but yeah.
I'll show you a crack this time, Rock. Rock showed his crack.
Man.
Okay. Roll it.
He had to come out of the booth.
Rock came over here to adjust the mic. Nothing but ass in the motherfucking cameras. I said, "Who the bitch in the room?" "It's the bitch here." I'm looking on her computer. I said, "It's a female with a gang of ass."
Not on that ass. Oh, it's
adjusting mics. I was like, "Mike." I said, "Rock, move out the way. It's a bitch in here somewhere. You are blocking this bitch with his ass."
Who's the bitch on technical support? She was hot.
This bitch got a onesie on.
What's that lady in the mom jeans? She looks good.
Y'all are crazy. One more story, you guys. A hotel in Zimbabwe is secretly taping people having sex and posting it to paid websites.
I'd be so pissed.
Whoa.
Zimbabwe?
Zimbabwe.
Why they gotta be secret in Zimbabwe? I doubt a camera's hidden in Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe. Right. Is that your name or just what you do? Zimbabwe.
Why are you secretive in Zimbabwe?
Right.
Nigga, if you there, 9 out of 10, I'm fucking.
They say that couples having sex in their hotel rooms are secretly being recorded, with the footage ending up online. The unnamed, a former employee claims this. He claims that it's common there and that a group of businessmen are responsible for installing the equipment that goes in there. It's a big money.
Zimbabwe. What's the other African country that be ganking motherfuckers?
Nigeria.
That's all the same shit. I'm just saying, I ain't saying all Nigerians get you, but 99.9.
Could you imagine?
Wait,
you,
so
you
all those
porn,
all those emails I responded to are not real? They're not going to give me the money?
You get the one where it says, "Hey, I'm doing really bad right now. Me and my son, but
got in the Philippines and got robbed.
Can you send me $15,000? I was like, "Who are you?
And why would I care?
Why am I sending you $15?
Right.
And hit
now,
you
know what they do is they hack into a friend's email, and it's like it's coming from a friend. It's somebody that you know. Like, it could say, "Poetess is out in the Philippines."
They do.
Or they hack you.
They
talk to you like, but apparently these people are making a lot of money. Can you imagine if you're on YouPorn or
and don't know it?
RedTube or why do I know all these sites?
Yeah, why do you know these?
I was like, interesting.
And your video pops up.
You put in hotel fucking
you're like,
amateurs.
Wait, that's me.
Yeah, hey,
I recognize that ass. That's me.
So you look at it and go, Rock?
Rock.
Are you adjusting? Are you adjusting cameras in Zimbabwe?
That's how I worked my way through school.
I started off in Zimbabwe and then I moved up here. Oh. You famous right now, Rock. You just don't know.
Yeah.
Motherfucker's gonna look at a Monday's thing and go, let me see.
And
Rock.
Did they film them in the daytime or they use night vision?
Yeah, how do they do it?
I'm just saying.
It has to be a night vision camera.
Yeah, it has to
be. Yeah, I'm sure they have.
I'm saying, with those dark motherfuckers down there.
I mean, it's it seems like an elaborate operation. I mean,
yeah, like, everybody fucks at a hotel.
They're making lots of money per week, per show.
Per show. It's showtime. Welcome to your room.
They said, actually, a lot of the sex workers, prostitutes, reel in guys. So it's sort of like a setup. Some of them are unsuspecting.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, right.
But some of them are prostitutes.
Hey, it's a teddy bear in here, but it don't move. I'm like, will not come off this counter.
And can you stand under this light when you fuck?
Can you slide over just a little bit? Really?
And action. Wait, what?
Wait, who's adjusting cameras? Rock?
And cut. Now we're switching to doggy style. Wait, what the? Why is there a director in the room?
Could you ever do a video?
I told you I did once.
Oh, that's right. Oh, now you can tell me that, but you can't tell me.
Yeah,
you
I did. Right. I did do it once. And
you
did?
Who has it?
It got I erased it because I was going through some footage and my family was around.
Hey, can I use your phone? No.
And this is Felicia when she went to New York.
I was going through the footage. I go, oh, look, Mom, this is when we were Christmas.
And this is Felicia.
No way.
And soon as she turned her back, the porn clip clicked in.
Oh, my God.
I almost slapped the camera down on the floor.
All you heard was, take your Timberlands off. Okay. But she had on Tim. Right. Hey, Moose, can you take your Tim's off? Okay, cool. Lacey's mom.
Now, this was years ago. I erased it right after.
And
that.
This is my baby
like,
with
I was
my
looking
beat.
For this.
Every time my daughter want to use my phone, I said, bitch, no.
Me too.
Like, Daddy, you call me a bitch. You
what's
right.
What's on your phone?
Felicia, what you doing with the whole Wu-Tang Clan? What are you doing with them?
She got them all lined up now. Just stay still. One you niggas move out of line, you're not getting them.
Felicia, apparently old dirty bastard wants his money. I don't know if you gave it to him yet.
No, I don't let nobody use my phone.
I don't need. I don't let kids.
You have to remember,
I let adults, but I don't let kids.
You have to remember
phone.
Too to clear your.
I don't
history.
Put nothing on my phone that I don't want nobody to see. You never know who will get a hold of that shit.
Well,
I have sessions on my shit.
Yeah. I already know Nikki Pam gets dick pics.
Yeah.
So on the regular.
Yeah, she has a library.
I do have a library. I really do.
You might have
I know
to post
each penis to who belongs to.
White dudes, you get white dudes?
She arranges dick by the decimal system. You have a fucking library.
A whole lot of nines in here. 2 7.
Let's pull up dick 1 7 2 3 6 5. Pull that up, please.
Oh, it's Rin Young Kim.
$10,000 man.
We found Rin Young Kim's dick pic.
Damn. And so they're selling the video of people fucking online they don't even know.
It's probably pay per view. They probably have a site set up and people pay to go.
We should find out what that is.
I know, I would love to see it. Just to see what the quality.
Yeah, it's almost like revenge. It's kind of revenge porn.
To go with that, I also saw where in Britain, apparently, is the number one place to have sex outside. That's like, that's what they do.
Outside.
Like, well, you know, in San Francisco, there's places where you can walk around butt naked, which I think is crazy.
Where?
I don't know about that.
I don't know.
Ashbury Heights is
that's the wrong city to walk around naked.
Yeah. I have a story in here where this couple was in Tampa, Florida, having sex on the beach.
Mm-mm. Oh, I saw this, I think.
Yeah, sex on the beach in front of everybody. And so a woman videotaped them. I mean, there was kids running around playing.
What?
And they
Hey, that dolphin is fucking that whale.
They were doing all the noises. They weren't discreet about it.
Oh, my God.
Dang.
So they got arrested, and the guy got 2.5 years.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I would have been pissed.
For fucking?
But the chick got off. So.
You think?
You can say that again.
No pun intended.
That's funny.
Yeah, so they were.
Where are the equal rights? Why did she get off?
Where did she get off?
He had a warrant. He had been arrested before for
fucking on the beach.
Fucking on the beach.
We told you to stop that.
How do you just do that? Come on now.
You never fucked at the beach?
But not in front of.
Wait a minute. So you fucked at the beach. You did some other shit, but you won't tell me you use a vibrator.
That's none of your business, sweetie.
You draw lines in the weird places. I understand.
She put a line in the sand.
So you fucked at the beach? Venice Beach?
No.
Hysterical.
Playa del Rey?
What?
Playa del Rey?
No, on a road trip up north to the bay.
Uh oh.
She got hyped.
She was in the car going, that sure is a nice beach. Pull your dick out.
No, leave your Timberlands on.
Just unzip, nigga. This nigga. Put some.
Y'all just putting me all out. Anyway.
I know you, freak. I know you. Because you two, your business side is so whore. Mm-hmm. I know once you get in that room, it's probably like, now hold this titty in this hand.
Put that titty in that hand. She instructs. She's not going to be passive aggressive at all.
Oh, God. Anyway.
You probably get on top and just ride it. Take this pussy.
Okay. Where do you want me to go with it? Where do you want me to take it?
You probably spin around and face the other way. Don't you move,
nigga.
They grab your feet. You ever have them grab your feet?
Yes.
Just me.
Okay. Well,
we know. Okay, I'm going too far.
Anyway, you are listening to the new Rollout Show at live from Morris Media Studios. The phone lines are open, 323-293-3375.
Tell us your story at the beach.
Yeah.
Who's yeah?
I'm saying yeah. Somebody else should call him. She said call in. He said call in, right?
Yeah. Oh, I thought he was asking me again. I already told my story.
No, he said call in.
Yeah, call in. Where's the weirdest place? Has anyone ever had sex in public? That should be the question. Because this is the... They're out in public in the beach.
No, Rock awesome. Keeps raising his hand from the booth.
Is he?
But it's...
Did you have sex?
Rock.
On a TV set? In front of wild-adjusted cameras.
On a hotel... the roof of the hotel.
Oh shit! Century,
but I didn't realize the hotel next to us was higher. BBW party.
Oh, Speedy!
On at the end of it.
Like it's showtime.
That sounds like one of Speedy's kind of parties. A BBW party.
Well, I'm just gonna let you know, big girls give it up. Mm.
Come out to the sex party at the Golden Corral. It's going down.
Right. Roll them in and roll them out. No, I don't know what it is about big girls, but. Guaranteed you can hit it that first night.
Come on down to the Golden Corral, get crab legs and crabs.
I'm just saying, and I'm not saying all big girls are big. Nah, I ain't like that. Wait, trust me, and most of the big girls I got at, we was in the back of my car. I don't know how we did it.
By playing Tetris.
And to over first.
Oh, God. I'm gonna put a square block here. We're going to break. We'll be back, you guys.
Roll his dick out in your mouth.
Oh.
Hysterical.
Difficulties. Oh,
there we go.
Here's something. There we go.
We are live. Apparently, somebody erased the word play. Rock is back there. There's a play button around this moment.
It's late.
The all new Rollout Show live from media. God damn it.
Morris
Media.
Let me see this.
The number calling to is 323.
We have four right now.
293-3375.
Four mess ups.
Y'all put a bet in the chat room to see how many times Speedy messes up the name. So far, he's
Morris
at four.
Media.
Oh, really?
So, yeah.
I got it written out, too.
Yeah, right in front of your face.
Right there.
I go right to media. Live from. Oh, Morris. I need to slide Morris
live
over.
Media yeah. From Morris. Outro roll. Oh, wait. I read that all wrong. It's Rollout Show live from Morris Media. 323-293-375.
Did you just say out show out roll? Roll.
Out,
say
show out roll. Roll. he will read everything on the prompter.
It's your boy Speedy in the house. We got
Poetess
and RT with the Caucasian Invasion.
Nikki Pam.
Wow, 2 days in a row.
I know, right?
Yeah. Poetess did though.
What?
Because P always, like, when she don't know something, and she was talking to me, she went,
I know, right?
That's when I know it's serious. I don't play then. I'm like, well, I asked her, you know, because I have to explain right then
she
and there.
She looked at me over the glasses.
Yeah, because yeah, she looked over the glasses.
We didn't clear that.
Speedy, the deadly girl.
I don't know about this.
Or she'll do
because
it.
Speedy will throw shit on you at the last minute. Wait, like, oh, I just thought of this idea. This, you know.
And then Poise go, we tried. I'll be like,
thank you.
And she'll go, okay, we speak. And then as she's walking away, it's just a certain way to do things, Speedy. You don't discipline me as you're walking away?
Yes, teacher.
But I love you. I know this shit ain't changed. This is what I missed right here. I need discipline.
Love you.
Just say you love me. You love me.
You do.
And boys, fuck the nigga that said something about my hairline. Fuck you. I got one.
And do you have a part?
Yeah, I was going with the Muslim bean pie. I wanted to try
Speedy
it.
Speedy has a part in his hair. I just
he
noticed
does?
That.
Yeah, I can see it.
Going with the bean pie.
You have a part.
Somebody nice. Say I look like Frankie Lyman.
I always say fuck you have the Martin Luther King hairline.
Oh, you niggas on the chat room. Some of you niggas ain't got no hair. At least I can brush.
Yeah, and I have a dream that I have a part one day.
Sorry, was that too soon? Too soon to make an MLK joke?
Yes, 50th Selma.
Right.
I don't think you should be saying no jokes about King Martha or the Luther. Let's try that.
Right.
Stay in your Confederate lane. That's what you do. I know your daddy got one of them flags at the house.
No, my daddy's from the North. My mom does. My mom has the flag.
Oh, she really does?
Yeah. No, no. But no, my
why is
dad's
the screensaver
mom
still up?
Was country as hell. So my dad's mom, he's her brother was in the Klan for sure.
Her brother?
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Your uncle?
No, my great uncle.
No, your uncle.
No, no, no.
Nah, yeah.
Still an uncle.
Don't try to, don't try to slide away
no,
from
no,
me.
No,
I
my
mean,
great uncle.
I had racism in my family, too.
You had racists?
Racist.
Or racism.
Oh, race. Okay. Racist pizza.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not raisins. Racist.
Because the other side is Italian. Right?
On the white side.
Amongst other things.
What else are they? Like German and all that shit?
Yeah. I got mixed. I'm
white.
Mutt.
You know, white.
You all fucked up. Who black? Your daddy a nigga?
My dad's black, but he has German in his bloodline.
Oh, he light skinned black.
You seen my dad.
German's
going oh,
down.
Shit. I got Mr. Morris. Okay.
Right. Morris.
I'm sitting there going, what does this nigga look like?
You know what he looks like.
Because I had to go with you and your daddy really? To buy a car. Your daddy was like, I ain't doing shit after 5.
He said he don't spend money after 5.
I was in the car going.
Really?
And it was $458. I said, well, you ain't going to get a car. We ain't even at the car lot.
What's his rationale with that, though, Portis?
Was he like that
way
growing up?
I don't know. I think
up?
That's how Jewish people do it or something. I don't know.
Really?
Was he
I
that way
know.
Growing up?
They're financial yeah. anti-vampires.
I think he was joking, actually.
Shit. Oh,
okay. Sweet as hell.
Yeah,
nah.
This money in his hand at 548.
Money burns up in the dark. Keep it in the light.
I want to do that thing where they do your heritage to find out where you came
oh,
from.
Oh, you did DNA?
Yeah, I want to do that.
Yeah.
I want to find out. Because I met my dad. And my stepdad's not my dad.
I'm guessing it goes back to Africa.
You know what? Ben Affleck did that, and
oh yeah, he tried.
He
to
found
say
out that,
that
his relatives owned slaves, and he was trying to hide that. Like, of course they did. Like,
yeah. I know. Like,
oh, really?
It's so dumb. Why would you try to hide it? It's
right.
Like,
and I think as a result of all that drama, I think they might have canceled that. That series, I think.
Which one?
No, or oh, his yeah. documentary.
Yeah.
Or,
yeah. When they,
oh, wow.
Because they were getting stars and motherfuckers yeah. was giving their family
oh,
treats.
Oh, your family's racist. I'm like, what?
Not me.
Like, yeah. I'm just playing.
Yeah. Well, I'm pretty sure the Steckles.
So if you came oh, up yeah. in a racist family, RT, what made you like
black women?
Well, no, well, that's the thing. It wasn't
persuasion.
Racist. My, put it this way. My grandmother was probably racist.
Mm. Now that you think
about it.
Now that I think about it.
Who the little nigga in my kitchen? Auntie, get this nigga out my kitchen.
My grandma told me she knew Uncle Ben.
Mm. Yeah, she racist. I thought he was a fictional character. He real?
He's real.
I know, I'm like,
apparently
really?
He's real, yeah.
Oh, I
and Aunt Jemima's supposed to be real, too.
Yeah.
Really? Wait, Uncle Ben
a
is
a friend
real?
Of mine
a real dude, yeah.
posted the picture of the real Aunt Jemima.
Aunt Jemima.
Or the
You say aunt Jemima?
You can say aunt. Aunt.
No,
aunt.
It's aunt.
Well, when she made money, she was an aunt. Before she started selling syrup, she's aunt.
Aunt Jemima.
She pronounced it
really.
With the, yeah. I didn't know that. But I didn't know Uncle Ben was real.
My dad was liberal, but I could tell my grandmother on my dad's side, who grew up in rural Georgia, like she was definitely racist.
I said, Auntie, get the niggas out of the kitchen. I got chicken in there.
So, but you still didn't answer Portis's question. Oh. So, where?
Yeah, how'd you slide over to the dark side?
Right.
Oh,
and black women per se.
How you start fucking?
Love you a black woman.
Black women because of the asses.
Oh, okay.
Forbidden fruit. What age?
What age? White men usually like big tits.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, we like fucking tats.
Right.
Okay, so what age? Like,
yeah. Did I get with a black woman?
When you went, damn, that's
ass. Oh, yeah, yeah. Shit, well, yeah, when I went to school, when you start going to school and you switch from, you know, flat iron board women to women with curves, you're like, what the fuck?
And so what made you go, I'm going to say something to the sister?
Just natural law of attraction, motherfucker. You can't help but be magnetized towards the ass. You end up walking.
So when you bring Shamika home,
right,
and your grandmother's there saying, "Who the nigga in the kitchen?" That's my date. Order to eat.
Well, the funny thing I noticed is when I was a kid, when I was younger, was that Atlanta has a street called Ponce de Leon,
yes,
and all the streets to the north they switch to white names. Yeah. In the South, they switch to black names. So if you go, like, it's Monroe to the north, then it switches to Boulevard to go south. And wow. It's Charles Allen to go north, but then it's Jackson to go south. So if I told my mother I was going to somebody's house and she'd ask where it was, so I'd say, oh, he or she lives off of Jackson, right?
Like, she knew where you
were
going.
Be home at 5. You know, anywhere else.
Going like, down there with them black folks.
After dark, it was cool. But then if it was somewhere else, it'd be like, be home early. You know, it's like,
first time you bought a black guy over, or a friend, what'd they say?
Nothing. They weren't like that.
Yeah. Fuck out of here.
So you could bring them over?
Yeah.
No, just can't bring them in the living room. You go in my room.
Through the back door.
Yeah, you can't walk around in
as
front of
as long as they stay in sight the whole time.
I need your hands up, please.
Keep an eye out. Keep an eye
Put
out.
Your hands where my eyes can see.
Your mom got a speakerphone. I need you in the kitchen.
So what you got for us, Speedy?
All right, so this is a new segment called the Cable TV Roundup with Pam and Speedy. Because we always watch the TV.
To do it.
And talking about it.
Yeah, well, so and one of my favorite shows, and this is just favorite shows, and if you like it as well, call it, is Power.
Oh, love it.
Power's but here's the problem. 50's on it now. And, you know, last year, 50 wasn't really in it, even though he's the executive producer. This year, he's up in there.
And is he a good actor? I haven't seen it.
Yeah.
Off the chain.
He's ruthless.
Oh, okay. Ruthless.
The only problem is, now, if you're a fan of The Sopranos, you know that when he never really got caught up really until toward the end. Matter of fact, his family didn't truly know what he did for a living until toward the end.
Right.
And this is only the second season for Power, and then he's almost getting tripped up. Omari Hardwick, his character Ghost is almost being tripped up, where last year he was just this guy who was making money and had a club, but he was a dope dealer, but nobody knew it.
Mm-hmm.
Second season, because they're writing too fast, he's almost getting caught up where everybody's going to know, oh, you're Ghost, and you're trying to have a club to clean your money and all that shit. But it's actually a great fucking show.
Well, isn't that, but his side chick is, it works for the police?
She's a DA.
They didn't know that, but now he knows she does, and now she's finding out he might be, because she thinks somebody else is
Ghost.
She thinks
the white dude, his best friend is Ghost. But he's not.
But it's a great show. Mm-hmm. The killing. Oh, no, they like killing. The they killing motherfucker. They killed killed the girl that was hitting everybody. She was like walking up on motherfuckers in Tim's and bow, putting bullets in them.
And Ghost's wife, Natari.
She used to be a singer. She was on.
She was in what, 3LW?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's off the chain. Now, people try
a lot of people
compare,
don't like her.
Really?
They don't like her.
I think it's, you know what it is. And I don't even want to say what it is.
Say what it is.
Because she's dark skinned and
she's actually
and
great.
Amari's like,
and isn't she Lil Wayne's baby mama?
It's Notori. Oh, I didn't know that. Really? Not Notori.
Well, she
played Little
right?
Kim
in Notorious.
Yeah. So I don't think it's her. No. And so.
She got a baby by somebody.
She does. She got a baby by somebody. You can Google it right quick.
People were mad because he was having the relationship with the Puerto Rican girl, but I said, she's Puerto Rican. It's okay. They were like, well, she looked white. Come on, let that shit go.
And then they're mad, okay, because the thing with Power, they're comparing it to Empire. I don't see
I think it's better than Empire.
I do too. Well, I mean, you can get away with way more stuff on cable than you can on Fox.
Even though they'll try. Fox will try.
They'll push the envelope, for real. But, I mean, I don't see the comparison at all. And I know that 50 was mad initially, but now that he's getting his due and people are really tuning in.
Yeah. And we're giving you these highlights just in case you haven't watched it. Mm-hmm. I think it's a great.
It's definitely a must-see.
It definitely must see. What do you have for a must-see?
Well, you know me and my reality. So, okay, I love Married to Medicine, right? So last week.
What the fuck is that?
Okay. It's doctors. It's some women are married to doctors and some are doctors. One's a gynecologist, the other's a dentist. And it, what goes on behind the scenes of their lives and how they intermesh. But last week, Quad and Lisa Nicole is a designer, got into a fight.
Oh, shit.
Now, this is the part that trips me out. And I want to know if you guys think this is okay. So apparently Lisa Nicole did a background check on Quad. And as friends, she's like, well, you know, I need to know who I'm hanging out with. Mm-hmm. So in return, Quad did a background check on Lisa Nicole. And all her dirt came out. Basically, that
they're all married to doctors.
Yeah. Okay. Married or two are doctors. Or no, three are doctors. And the other are married to doctors.
Okay, gotcha.
So it comes out from Lisa Nicole that from Quad that her husband had was having affairs and he had a baby out of wedlock.
Ooh.
So is it okay to do a background check on an alleged friend? And then they got into a fight.
Me and you, we cool, we kicking it.
Yeah.
We don't.
And then
do
you're like, I might do some business with Speedy or something like that. So I'm gonna do a background check on
him. Shit, I'll beat your ass.
I do background checks on people that I'm doing big business with.
You do?
You do?
Yeah.
But are you guys friends? I mean, these girls were friends first, and then midstream, she's like, I'm going to do a background check on you. And
it's not. I don't think there's anything wrong with that.
Really?
Because it's difference between
personal. So you
would
do a background check on me?
And there's a difference between business. Your I already know your background.
Your
I don't even need
to. We don't need to.
The computer blew up.
Right.
RT, would you back?
Would you do it on a friend?
I would ask you first. And then if I feel like.
Ask me what?
Have you ever had this?
Lawsuit,
done this?
You got child support, garnishments.
Yeah,
hold on. We not in business. You just my friend.
Oh, no, but she said the girl went into business.
Well, they were supposed. Well, this is what Quad says that they weren't. She said, I was just asking your business advice. Lisa Nicole took it like, well, I was going to invest in you, but I need to know who you are. And like you said about garnishments and all that stuff. And then Quad flipped, hired a private investigator and was like, found out stuff about her and her husband. And she had a domestic charge against her that was exposed.
So this is one of them juicy kind of
It's really juicy and it's really like, I'm like, ooh. And they fight.
She found some messed up stuff though. When she
She found. But Lisa,
that intuition talking.
Yeah, but basically her husband had a child out of wedlock, and then so she confronted her with it, and then she threw a glass at her, cut her in the face.
Well, her husband is a doctor. As soon as I get this shit, I'm going to beat your ass.
Okay, move on. What's the next thing?
I like that. Now, another show that I think everyone should watch, and you know, we want you to call in and let us know if it's a certain show that you watch. That's the shit. But Murder in the First.
Tell us about that.
Murder in the First starring Taye Diggs and Kathleen Robinson. Mm-hmm. Very, very good show. TBS, I think it's on. Mm-hmm. And there's a brother on the show. Plays a leader of a gang member. It's all based in San Francisco. And his brother, his name is Mo Murray.
Murray.
McRae.
We're going to do a background check on your pronunciation.
Mo McRae. Anyway, his character is so hard on this shit. Mm-hmm. Because he's killing and doing all kind of shit and he don't pay attention to the person he's talking to. So his nephew, his cousin, killed somebody he wasn't supposed to. They sealed this motherfucker up in the wall and painted it up and kept it pushing. And dude didn't think, he's like, I'm your cousin. Yeah, well, you'll learn next time, won't you? Go on and seal him up. And they walked out the house. It was a house that was boarded up.
God.
They sealed him in the wall, put up the drywall and painted it and gone about their business. And
Taye Diggs has a job.
But Taye Diggs is very good
job,
in this.
Keeps doesn't he?
And I thought the show was just about like murder in the first of one particular thing, but it's really about a whole bunch of different murders, and they all handle it in San Francisco. But it's very on the edge.
Does he play the cop?
He's a detective. Yes.
Okay.
Matter of fact, he's one of the lead detectives, and he's fucking one of the police officers that work under him. Okay. It's kind of weird. White girl. Anyway, no, she's Mexican. There. She's Mexican. Stop that. She's Mexican.
Just saying.
But it, I'll definitely say it's a good show to go watch. If okay, you're at the house chilling,
check it out.
I'm gonna check it out.
Murder in the First, Power, and then my throw-in would be Love and Hip Hop Atlanta because they act.
It is off the chain. They,
I watch that whenever I'm flicking through.
I just, here's my thing. Jocelyn,
mm-hmm, Jocelyn
Hernandez. She only has an accent when she's doing her one-on-one shots.
It is a little strong.
When she's
than...
talking to everybody else, you don't hear the accent.
Not as bad.
Huh? I'm just saying. check out the show. Like when, because they all have to do the one-on-ones where they talk to the camera.
Right.
And her accent is very, very heavy. When she's talking to other people, she's like, "What, bitch? What?" And like, "Where's your accent, bitch?" I like the show.
Okay, so mm-hmm. Nikki Pam, I know you've probably witnessed like the behind
the
scenes
real truth
of reality shows. What are some things people don't really realize about reality shows that we don't see on camera? I know that it's they written. Fuel a lot of it with alcohol. I mean, every time Absolutely. You see somebody, they going to have drinks and getting fucked up. I mean,
well, I will say this. Okay, the difference between, say, like a Real Housewife and Love & Hip Hop.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all know I've been around both. So Love & Hip Hop, those situations are kind of real and do spawn from certain things.
Mm-hmm.
So what they'll do is like, they'll have meetings and say, "Oh, okay, this is going on in your life. Mimi, Nico, da-da-da-da-da, Jocelyn and whatever." And then they'll say, "Okay, you need to be at this place in this certain time."
And y'all talk it out.
And you talk it out. Okay, now, what's the other one I said? Real Housewives. Uh-huh. Real Housewives. It's more fabricated. It's not really spinal. You know, they really do a storyline arc and they put it up on the board and they don't know when they're going to always be set up or questioned, but they'll say to Cynthia, "I need you to confront Phaedra about this." Mm. Go, type of thing. So, but the thing about Love & Hip Hop, what I like, it is definitely like the Mimi, Nico, that stuff is real. I mean, I've been there when
so
Nico
showed what
up
is
the
young,
house.
What is Young Jock's claim to fame?
Wasn't he a rapper? Poetess?
Hmm?
Yeah, wasn't Young Jock?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he broke now because he lived with the one?
The girl, yeah, I noticed that he's living off of chicks.
Yeah, she used to be his assistant and the one that kept all his business together.
Yeah,
and
but then, I mean...
She was putting up with all his side chicks in the beginning,
and
but
he
now...
He got side chicks.
Don't he?
But now she's like, you have to cut all that off.
No, but now she's letting him back in the house. That's what I don't get. Mm-hmm. I said, man, what the fuck was I... Because if I'd lived in Atlanta, I'd probably be doing the same. Because Atlanta...
There's nothing else to do.
It's dying business. It's just broken. Not broke, but they got it going on and don't handle man. But the girl that he's with now, she's a real estate... She handles real estate.
Well, see, that's arguable.
Now, that might be.
Yeah, that's arguable.
But at the end of the day, I'm trying to figure out what did he do? That's the one from back in the day that used to be with Diddy.
Yeah.
Lean.
No.
What did he just see? Meet me at the trap. Didn't he meet me at the trap?
Meet me at the trap.
Yeah, exactly.
Meet
me at the mall.
A mall, it was a little
Where do you want me to meet you, guys?
Okay, and what's Stevie J's claim to fame?
Well, he did used to work with your producer, and he worked with a lot of people, and he was with
Eve,
Diddy.
Eve and a bunch of other
artists. Yeah, and he actually had a relationship with Eve, and actually, you know who else he had a relationship with that people don't know?
Oof.
God, Lord, don't let me get sued. Allegedly, Whoopi Goldberg's daughter, the one that has the kids now. He used to be with her before Eve. And then Eve, and then to Mimi.
Well, Mimi looks better in her one shots when she's actually out and about. Because and I notice how they do the show where they always say where they're going, and the show must go in and clear it out and put their people
you have
in.
To. You have to,
because people start an argument and nobody turns around.
Yeah,
nobody like me, motherfucker, and everybody be still. So I'm just eating. I'm like, and I'm looking in the background. Why ain't no?
Yeah, you're like somebody.
But when we did,
so what they do for the rest, like they say,
are they going, extras?
Yeah, I would assume they are.
Yeah. Like they say, they're going to sign a clearance sheet. Yeah.
Wow,
they have them at
crazy.
The door. They do,
because they start an argument and it's real.
I wonder if they the the places give it to them free for the advertising.
They do, because the first thing they do, they'll say they're going to so-and-so. They'll put the name of the establishment, and they get in, and then people go, so, bitch, I heard this, that, and the other. Mm-hmm. And the next thing you know, everybody else is still doing it. And these motherfuckers are going 50-150. Security done stepped in, and everybody's still eating. So, change.
So, you know, if they're in, they're in a club, they really do turn off the music to shoot.
Yes.
So, when we were at, we did the party for Claudia. The music was down. The music was low, and they shot the scene.
Everybody's acting like,
but really, you know, there's no music.
Let me ask you this. Mm-hmm. Was the beef really real between Claudia and NeNe?
Yes, it was. Well, put it like this. The producers say, go after this person.
Mm. You know, you could tell that's obvious.
Yeah. It wasn't no. They didn't hate each other.
That's obvious that she was egged on to do that.
Yeah, she was egged on to do that for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's what it's a segment. And then, like I said, it's just these are just shows that I.
Spice
every week,
it up.
Wednesday, we'll have shows that you should probably check out just because I think they're hot.
Yeah,
and your third one was what?
No, that's it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Love to hear about. And that's.
That's it? What's it called? Cable? You need a better name
it's
than that.
Cable TV Roundup.
Thank you. I got it right here if you let me use my finger. You know, I don't appreciate you. See,
Porter,
y'all don't know what you're doing because you can see the shit. So the whole time, I can feel your energy like.
right.
And then she'll wait for you to have a little space. What else you got?
And next. Moving on.
So now, next. As the person doing, you got to put your own energy in shit. So, okay, now another one I got. I ain't even looking at you. I'm looking at her, trying to get her approval.
You need me in your life, Speedy.
No, I don't.
You need
me. I need you to stop staring at me.
Life.
That's what the fuck. Because your energy was like, you were like this the whole time.
Probably because I don't watch any of those shows. I'm like, you I've heard of Power. I've heard of Love and Hip Hop.
Murder in the First
that.
Is really good.
This has been the Cable TV Roundup brought to you by Golden Corral. Just remember, you can sleep in the parking lot. See you for breakfast.
Hit us up. The phone lines are open, 323-293-3375. And remember, again, the Rollout Crew will be in Palm Springs.
Yes.
Not this coming weekend, but
next
weekend. Next
weekend, we're in Palm Springs. Also, too, I still got, somebody said it on the thing. I bet Speedy still got a t-shirt. That's why I ain't changed the name. You're right. I got 6,000 t-shirts and hoodies.
What's my t-shirt?
You got to come get it.
Oh, man.
You guys, please support if you want a Rollout t-shirt or a Morris Media t-shirt. It does cost money to do the shows. I don't want to get into the whole, you know, donating thing, but, you know, purchase our t-shirts or whatever we have to offer to support the show.
And you can still go to speedyandfriends.net. It's speedy, the letter N, .friends.net. And yours is?
You could just hit me up at OG Poet.
Just hit me up on Twitter.
Just call
her. Hit me up on Twitter,
we're working on it, right.
Like, just call me, bitch.
Right.
We're working on our website right now.
It's in there.
Speedy kind of rushed me into this whole thing. I wasn't really 100% ready. I had to go rush and get everything because Speedy was like, we got to do it on this date. We got to do it. I said, Speedy, but I... No, we got to do it on ourselves.
It's the blame game.
Sponsored by Golden Corral.
So, yes, we're still getting everything together, you guys. So, you
Did you just throw me under the bus? Very politely?
Under the bus and the pickup truck and the 18-wheeler.
That's not throwing you under the bus.
Yes,
that's just showing how excited you are and passionate you are about keeping the radio going.
And when you stare at me and go...
Now what you got?
What else you got?
Your energy is... that's why your man, the guy you're dating, has to love you. Cause,
damn it.
Damn.
I don't know
fuck?
Why he keeps doing that.
Take
it
off vibrate.
Damn, it's your vibrator. When are you going to use me? Hurry up and use me. I'm lonely. I'm lonely in your purse.
You remember on that episode of South Park with the shake weight?
Yeah, the shake weight.
I caught the tail end of that. And then the shake weight was talking to...
Yeah.
What the fuck happened to that?
Shake it a few more times.
Yeah.
And then when it's done shaking, it spurts on you.
Yeah. Yeah, lotion is first.
Okay, I caught the end of it, and I'm flipping the channels. I'm like, and the lady's talking to the shake weight. The shake weight, I'm going to go ahead and turn myself off now. I'm like, what the fuck?
One of the funniest ones is the cable one, where they have to call the cable company, and they make fun of how
monopolized the cable industry is. Uh-huh. And basically, you only have one or two services you can use. Yeah. And so basically, the people at the cable company get off on you calling. So they're like, oh, we're only going to be able to make it tomorrow between 9 and 5. And everyone on their shirts, they have like a button flap so they can open it up if they just want to directly touch the cable. And so they just talk about how much they can fuck you.
Oh, like, my God.
Well, you know, you can only get the total package for $200 a month. Oh.
I have DirecTV. DirecTV don't give a fuck about you.
No, they don't care about
you. They don't care about what you're going through. I call the lady up. She says, yeah, you've been a customer for 3 years. I said, yeah, I ain't going to be able to make the payment. She said, well, you made a payment arrangement, and you have to stick with it. I said, well, can I get an extension? No. I said, is anything? No. I said, somebody, no. If you don't pay it, it'll be off.
Time Warner is the same way.
I went to go, bitch. And then she was like, it will be off if you don't pay. Because they give you a 5-day extension on your when you got to pay it. And at the end of that 5, you don't have that money in that motherfucker at 501.
Bitch. What bothers me is this pisses me off. It's like I'm paying X amount for whatever, you know, cable channels and movie channels and this and that. And, you know,
internet.
Yeah.
Too much stuff.
And so then they send like. They send a flyer to the door that's like, get DirecTV, $29.95 a month. And I'm like, why the fuck am I paying $150?
Right.
You pay $150?
You got to be a new customer.
For all the shit, it's like $100.
I pay $380 a month.
Well, yeah, it's like $100
damn, you must have everything. Yeah, but I pay $220-ish. Yeah, exactly. No,
I got power.
You got the Zimbabwe porn channels is what you got.
Yeah, I got. Because my thing is, I want every channel just in case I miss some. Because, you know, the minute you just get HBO, don't shit come on. Okay. And then everything be on Star or be on Showtime.
Or Showtime, yeah. It always switches up. Fact. So what I do is I call in like, because I like the show, what is it, something sex. I forgot what it's called. But anyway, so when that's on, I'll switch to Showtime. Or like when Bill Maher's on, I'll do HBO.
Yeah, like Bill Maher.
So,
yeah, Bill Maher's good.
I love Bill Maher.
All right. We got any calls? No? 323-293-3375. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back.
DJ Twin, you ready to do something?
DJ Twin in the mix. In fact, you can find DJ Twin on Twitter and Instagram at LA's own DJ Twin, and that's with two N's.
You think?
At the end.
Twin and the night.
Yeah, so if you need a DJ in your life, you just hit him up. He's only 2 feet tall, but he's standing on the box. He's 6'6". Yo, we are back. We are back. It's the all-new rollout show live from Morris Media. The number to call into if you want to talk with us is 323-293.
You forgot
studios. Yeah. Had to mess it up somehow.
293-3375. That's 323-293-3375. In the building is your boy Speedy. Also in the building we have
Poetess.
And RT the white boy is in the house. What's
and
up,
joining y'all? Us with his golf shirt on is...
Hey, don't disrespect my polo. This is Kente Scott representing the Yay area.
There we go.
Oh,
from the Yay.
Yeah, Dub Nation.
Now you like him, ain't that a bitch? Where you from, Sally Andrew?
Oakland. Oakland, yeah, that's right.
Piedmont. You from Piedmont.
Whatever, they didn't let us in there.
All right, we got a lot of stuff we're going to talk about. I like my segment last. That last segment, I like. I like TV shows.
Photos like, meh.
Like, strong segment, weak title.
I'll get a call in on that. Speedy. What you got for us? White ball.
Oh, is that what we're doing?
Let's do it.
Well, apparently so. We're doing white people news.
Who better to do it?
Can't have Kente do it.
We're going to do white people news. Everybody knows about Jared, I guess. You guys heard that.
No.
Subway drops Jared as their spokesperson after a raid at his home for child porn. Subway is suspending their partnership with Jared Fogle amid the investigation of his link to child pornography. Jared Fogle's attorney said in a statement that the Subway pitchman is cooperating with law enforcement.
You think?
And is looking forward to the conclusion after police raided his home on Tuesday. Fogle's attorney, Ron, another a white name, released a statement after police arrived outside Fogle's home and an evidence truck was parked in the driveway along with multiple police vehicles.
Put the sandwich down and where the kids. Yeah.
So I guess someone in his camp, I guess.
I think the guy that was running his nonprofit organization was busted with a gang of child pornography, like hundreds of videos and files. They went to his house first. got all that. I think that guy has been arrested, but I guess because
he told,
he dry snitched.
Because
you know who I work for? Me and Jared, real tight.
Right.
So, we don't do sandwiches only.
His address 555 Subway Lane.
Right. So I guess they figured this guy was tied to Jared somehow, and now the
Jared
investigation.
Is a bit of fish.
So apparently, Jared likes little kids on wheat.
Oh, way too soon. So you saying he like black kids?
Well, I'm saying he got in trouble for Googling child corn is what he tried to say.
Got plenty of kids meals at the house though. Want a juice box, little John?
Look, that's man. Something you just there's no way out of that. You don't want to be associated anything with
pictures, with nothing.
That's just horrible.
What's worse about being accused of being a child or a pedophile or a child molester is like, even if it's not true,
it's too late.
That stigma is going to be on you anyway.
You're the old dude with the creepy white van.
And you see, and my guess is even if he's completely innocent, it's going to be very, very difficult for him to make a comeback. You're not going to see him on any.
He might as well get fat again. He like, forget it. You know, this skinny shit ain't working. I'm about to be fat as hell.
Yeah, just fry all the subs.
Yeah, exactly.
Damn. Yeah, he's in trouble. Because
Jared, and they had all the pictures of Jared holding up the big jeans like we didn't know who Jared was.
Two little kids popped their head out the side.
My new Oshkosh Bagosh. All right, any more white people news?
No, we ain't going to just run past that.
We're not running past that.
We're going to hang out there for a minute.
Seriously, man. Here's the thing about that particular stigma, and you're right. It's certain things that's just going to stay with you. You ain't going to shake. Mm-hmm. If you rape somebody, child pornography.
Yeah,
whether you did it or not, the minute your name is in that, it's like, you the rapist. No, nigga, I didn't get filed guilty for that.
So they've canceled, you know, Jared wanted to initiate a new program for 3-inch subs. And so they decided against that for the little subs. So
little hand size subs.
But you're right. You can't be associated with that at all. And then just, it's not going to work. So they're going to suspend him. But my guess is it's over.
I wonder if Chris Hansen showed up.
Yeah.
Hey, Jared. That's right. When you know, you see Chris Hansen anywhere you at. Oh, nigga.
Like, hey, you come out my bathroom. So you got the lemonade for the 12-year-old. You thought it was cookies. So what happened, Jared?
Oh, real shit. Oh, real shit, though. I love my favorite part about that is how they try to deny like they're there for sex. And they're like, you weren't here for sex. Then what is the Bartles and James and condoms doing?
Well, I heard she was home alone, so I wanted to make sure her daddy had plenty of Coronas.
Yeah. Well, we're like, they naked already. So why you have your clothes off? It was hot in here.
Air conditioning my favorite was somebody tried to say, you know, well, I'm trying to protect them from weirdos. There's a lot of weirdos out here. You're like, you? Coming to the house?
They asked Chris, they said, dude said, well, who are you?
Yeah, that's what I did.
No.
Yeah. But how long was you in the bathroom? What was you doing in the bathroom, Chris?
Why are you here?
Yeah. You was here before me, Chris.
One dude said,
where the bitch with the cookies? I'm going to fuck this bitch either way it goes. She going to get this dick.
And then you see the one where dude had the kids in the car and his sister?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, the whole family out there. We was going to Magic Mountain. He said we'd be out in 5 minutes.
After I fuck this bitch, we going
Also, they got the worst names, too. It's like, so you weren't here to have sex with her? No, not at all. Is your name I Fuck 16-Year-Olds 59? On- Okay, it is. You got me. Like, is that your web name?
And then the dude be like, no. Yeah. So you didn't say, I want to put all this big dick in your little pussy.
Not all of it.
And, and then that's when they motherfucker look around and go, can I leave?
Yeah.
You can leave. Like, go ahead. And that's when that camera come out.
Be like, try and make it to the car with that. Go ahead.
So can I finish the Mike's Hard Lemonade first?
All right. Okay. Chris.
Yeah, so they just think they're going to just walk right up out of
there. They used to, just so people know, when they first did the show, you were able to leave.
Yeah,
because they couldn't arrest. Didn't know what to do.
Yeah,
and then it was then I think it got Oprah involved.
Yeah, Oprah.
And
they got the police involved.
Said, how come the police are not there? So they changed it. So now you know Chris Hansen don't even do that no more.
Nah.
Oh, he doesn't.
Nigga, he can't even go in the grocery store no more. He go in the grocery store aisle 7. Everybody leave.
I ain't doing
shit. Hey, what are you doing in the bread aisle? Nothing.
I'm not touching kids.
No, he does reports now, like at the mountains and shit. He don't do that shit no more.
Mm. They got bears be running out the woods when he comes through the mountains.
This is my cub.
The mountain lions. He's not my cubs.
If I want to fuck a cub, I can fuck a cub. It's mine.
Bears get scared of his ass. All right, more white people news. Paula Deen apparently is back in the news again.
What's she do?
Paula Deen's hitting the delete button sudden on her social media fired the manager for reposting an old photo of her son Bobby in brownface. I don't know what.
They were doing. They were mocking the I Love Lucy show, and the son was Ricky Ricardo. Wow.
So put him in brownface.
They put him in brownface.
What's wrong with this bitch? She just could not.
And she was Lucy. First of all, your son is Ricky. That's gross.
Yeah, you're Lucy.
You're Lucy. Hey, Ricky.
Wait a minute. Make sure I got this shit right. So they said, you want to do, let's do something.
Yeah, let's do baby pics.
Let's do, let's be Lucy and Ricky.
Okay.
All right, cool. You ain't dark enough.
I'm going to put you a brown face.
What's a brown face?
But mama.
Ain't nobody going to try.
What about them people you had dressed up like slaves? It's different. It's brown face. Yeah. They get mad at the black.
You're ladies. Ricky. You're Cuban.
Nobody cares.
They closer to the border.
So, in the picture, he just smiling too. He's like, I love my mom. We ain't never going to work again.
How old is he?
He's a grown man.
No, it was a baby.
Oh. No, he's a grown man.
He's a grown man.
Here it is right here is the picture.
37 years old in brown face.
Oh, no way. I thought it was a baby.
No, that's, that would be even worse.
I thought they were doing little baby pictures, and but it's a real person.
And she can really cook.
Grown up person.
No, she can really cook. Yeah. Here's the sad part about it.
She uses a lot of butter and grease.
Yeah, everything's good with butter.
Which means she can really cook.
She can really cook. I don't give a fuck.
Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a piece of shit. We're going to deep fry it, put some salt and pepper on it, put some butter in it. It's delicious. Hey.
And some cumin. They put cumin in everything. Hey.
Sidebar. On that fried, I just got back from New Orleans. I had some fried corn.
Oh, it was good.
Oh, my God.
Good as hell.
Fried corn?
Yeah, it's fucking delicious. Dude, put some ranch dressing on it. Deep fried corn. Oh, my God. It goes down.
I never had that.
Yeah, I didn't either.
They don't have that.
They don't have that in California, no. You got to wait till the Pomona County Fair comes out.
Here's my thing with her. I think she could be a very nice person. Bad decisions, but she's from the South. She's from the deep South.
Yeah.
She's not from Georgia.
Nah.
Is it South Carolina? No,
either way,
South Carolina is.
She's from a country area. You can tell how she talks.
And the fact that you would have your son even color his face, okay, do the Ricky thing. He could have had the pompadour. That's all you really need.
And Ricky wasn't really dark.
He wasn't even dark skinned.
He wasn't
because he wouldn't have made it on. Cuban. He wouldn't have made it on network TV back then.
But the problem, the funny thing is too, is apparently like the manager. Accidentally posted it again. So
accidentally?
She was.
Accidentally?
Yeah, right.
No, like, she was mad.
Yeah, she was mad at
so
let me start this shit back up.
Has she got back on TV? She was back on.
She was back on. She was on Steve Harvey's show.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm going to leave that right there.
Yeah, you're trying to get viewership. There.
Steve, you need to call it.
On them neighborhood awards.
It used to be called.
It used to be the hoodies.
Hoodie awards.
The
hoodies.
Got that NBC money.
Had to clean that up.
You have to change this to the neighborhood awards, Steve.
Okay. I do. Works for me. What else we got for you? You got one more?
Yeah, I got one more. So, again, Trump. Everybody knows the news about Trump. But for saying about the Mexicans and rapists about immigration. Now, so apparently NASCAR has now suspended all association with Donald Trump about this. Now, you know it's fucked up if NASCAR says you've offended the Mexicans.
And Trump was like, I thought they shared the same view on immigration. Like, you thought they were down with that.
Like, you're an idiot.
Like, that's our fan base. We know. We just can't tell everybody.
So, and that's another thing. Like, if you, we were talking about this earlier. Like, if you're a comedian or whatever, you're allowed to, you can make jokes and they might be crude or crass or whatever. But this is Donald Trump, a guy that's running for president. Yeah. It just says some foul-mouthed shit.
I'm going to be honest. I'm not even mad at Donald Trump because at least he's keeping shit real. You know who he is. There's no fake. There's no... He's unapologetic about it. I mean, he is who he is.
But would you vote for him?
Hell no.
No.
But he kicked it up
but
like
I heard he's leading in the polls, according to Fox. I mean,
exactly.
Because the Republicans have nobody. They're really searching. They have no platforms to run on. You know,
they got the same dudes that ran last time all running again.
Donald Trump's platform is racism.
That's
run on the racist ticket.
I want to divide everyone. So he's just a knucklehead. But you're right. Everybody does know where he stands.
Mm-hmm.
So you do have to give him a little credit for that. But what I don't like is people are supporting this. Like there are some people that are supporting this.
Oh yeah, they definitely do that. Can you look up? They also with that story. I don't know if you Amy Schwartz is that her name? She says something racist. She's a comic.
Amy Schumer.
Schumer.
Yeah.
Actually, she's very funny.
Hilarious. I like Amy Schumer.
She's actually very
funny. She's one of the shows I do watch on Comedy Central.
I tried to. I like her. I didn't understand it.
I think
anyway,
she's funny. And yeah, she said something. A Mexican joke.
Yeah. A Mexican joke.
Yeah, she did a Mexican joke.
But she's a comedian like RT said.
Right, and so that's what I'm saying.
What was the joke, though?
I don't remember exactly how the joke went, but it was something about Mexicans having sex with her and about working hard or whatever. It was kind of a stereotypical.
Yeah, what's her name does the
Mexican
same kind
joke.
Of jokes. What's the...
Well, here's the thing, because...
Lisa Lampanelli?
Yeah.
But this is the difference between her and Lisa, is that they're trying to shoot her up as that next white, funny white girl in movies.
Yeah.
You know, how's the big girl from...
Melissa McCarthy.
So right now, Melissa McCarthy is getting all the comedy, any comedy movies, she's getting them. Now, Amy is coming along, and they're saying she's not fat, and she's cute, and she appeals, and they're trying to slide her into that spot.
Well, I don't know how she is as an actress, but I enjoy her show on Comedy
Central.
Well, she has a movie out with...
Trainwreck.
LeBron.
Yeah, with LeBron. He actually executive producer. Wow.
Yeah. Mm. But so the thing, so they're making a big deal out of Amy because she now, because she's getting a lot of the limelight.
Yeah.
She apologized for making those jokes, and personally, as a comedian, I don't think you should apologize.
Because that means somebody else had now. Because what it does, it's a slippery slope. Because comics, we should be able to express however we feel. You can't say the word fag, but you can say sissy or homosexual.
Or you can say bitch.
We can?
Yeah, cool.
Bitch ass.
But yeah, so it's completely different when Donald Trump says something that might be off the cuff, but Amy Schumer says it. So it's kind of a big deal that Amy Schumer would apologize as a comedian, and Donald Trump is standing his ground and not apologizing.
Donald Trump is
because
like,
Donald Trump has fuck you money. Yeah, he has the kind of money where he don't need. Yeah. He don't need it.
He's like, I've been bankrupt twice. What y'all gonna do this time?
Right.
Every other entertainer would have apologized with that many sponsors leaving. I mean, if you saw the list of sponsors that left Trump,
and
it's
he's actually really surprised at some of them.
He's shocked.
Well, because he know him personally. Like, motherfucker, you told me to say this.
I know. He's like, I know Ronald McDonald.
And see, he wants Sunday to be president. That's
he's
the thing. Yeah.
He's Mexican under there. It's Ronaldo McDonald.
Can you imagine? What if he became president?
Oh. I'm moving to Canada.
Yeah,
I really don't think he'll make it. No, I'm not saying hey, this shit is.
It'd be hard.
There's a lot of Latinos and Spanish people.
Yeah, he definitely will not get
that vote. And Mexicans and Puerto Rican. I mean,
I can't wait for the debates.
Yeah. Well, that's why I actually hope he makes the debates because it'll make that shit entertaining as hell. I
as
love
a comic. Yeah. Oh my God! Last the two years ago, when my man from Texas.
The pizza guy?
From Texas. He couldn't remember the shit.
The branches.
Yeah.
All the people he wanted to get rid of. He said, and I'm watching it, and when they motherfucker went, whoo.
He even admitted, he's like, oh, I had a little brain lapse there.
Yeah.
And you're like, oh, boy.
And then somebody tried to help him, and they said something. He went, nah, not them.
Not them.
And
they're like, oh, yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, he was doing the branches of the of government or something, and he just couldn't. There's judicial, there's... I had a brain lapse. Right? I can't remember.
Like, start drinking the water.
And right then, because I watch it. So right then, I knew he was done.
Yeah.
So every time somebody fuck up, they're done. Except for Donald Trump.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Because they even try to help him. Like, yo, maybe you should. He like, nah.
And like, your clothes are made in China. Your clothes are made in Mexico. That's not the point. The point is, they come to America, I sell them, I get rich. But I don't want nobody else to come to America and get rich.
And then, what about all the workers that work at his hotels?
Yeah.
I mean...
They
his golf course, because ain't no white folks cutting that grass.
Yeah, and no, matter of fact, they moved all the golf tournaments that used to be on his golf course. They moved them all. Every single one of them.
That's some good money right there.
Yeah, the Pro Tour had a couple of them on his...
Fuck golf. Yeah, I hate golf. You ever play?
Mm-mm.
It's fun.
It's 4 hours of my life I'll never fucking get back. That shit is fun.
And it seems like when people do get into golf, they are really into it.
It's very expensive sport.
They're addicted. Yeah,
it's very expensive. And I need left-handed clubs. And it was.
So you're doing too much. You got too many damn excuses already.
I'm sorry. We finished your segment, but I had to get into this golf
thing. Hit us up, 323-293-3375.
Because a lot of comics are golfing.
Yeah,
and they call me like, "Yo, you want no?"
Alex Thomas, I see him out there.
All the Negroes think they are phenomenal too.
Cedric the Entertainer,
I'm killing it on golf course. You get out there, you be like, "Man, you lost 12 balls already. You're just as bad as I am."
Do you play, Kente?
I play, but I count by the number of balls I have at the end of the game. I be like, "I had 3 balls left. I did pretty good this time.
I won."
You came with a box of
24.
Yeah,
me with 3. That's a good day.
It's the hardest sport to do because you actually have to be perfect.
Yeah,
and you can never be perfect.
And you have to be like,
you have to hit that ball square every single time just to get it down the fairway.
And the less athletic you are, the better. Like, if you ever played another sport,
yeah,
you got to forget all that stuff.
Because it don't make no sense.
Well, then, Speedy, you should be pretty good. If you don't have any
athleticism.
Right.
He got the force in him. He just don't want to let it out. Come on, Luke.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Because you would take that time to decide you want to do comedy.
I was waiting. She did it so smooth,
I'm
though.
Serious. I don't look at you as an athletic person.
What the fuck? Did you double down?
She did. Twice. Bam, bam. You see his class ring from the
We're here at the Golden Corral Open. Look at Speedy by the shrimp table. Speedy's moving by the biscuits. Look at the athleticism.
I remember when him and Claudia were going to have a race.
And I was winning until I pulled my hamstring.
I was winning until I pulled a hamstring in a race against a girl. Don't ever say that again out loud, Speedy. I love you like a play cousin. I was winning till I pulled my hamstring and lost to the girl. That's what all it just happened. That's all that happened right there. I'm sorry.
Well, the funny thing was, Speedy didn't even use like any Icy Hot on the hamstring afterwards. He just put like mayonnaise and mustard on it.
Put Paula Deen butter on the back. It works. It works.
Blackface on it.
No, but Speedy was winning, but he did.
Let's keep it real.
They would say, who's in the grassy knoll? Because it looked like he got shot.
He got shot.
Wait, how far was the race?
12 yards. It was 12 yards. No, it was 100 yards.
At a good 6 on that? You ran 100 yards? No, who runs a 100-yard sprint?
He didn't.
Anyway, as grown folks.
All right, let's make sure we got it correct. I play varsity baseball.
This
varsity
is high school
football.
Sports. This is high school.
When?
Whenever you
got to
put varsity on it, it's high
make
school.
Make sure we get this right. I lettered in all three sports in high school.
So what was Ty Cobb like?
I was dunking.
Donuts.
I was dunking
donuts.
In the ninth grade. I could dunk. Two hands, throw down on anybody.
On a twist.
So having Satchel Paige as a teammate, how was that? What was that like playing with us?
Just to correct you, poetess, I am a very athletic young
man. So the first year they had face masks, that's when you start playing? You and Jim Brown?
Leather helmets.
No.
Uh-huh.
Just checking.
And here's the cold shit. I played ball with you. And you're the black hole. You pass the ball to RT, nigga, go down court.
Hey, as long as
that was hitting, if he make one, it's a wrap.
As long as my shooting elbow is good, I'll be good.
My shooting elbow.
Yeah, I can play in a wheelchair.
First of all,
I am very upset right now. Poets, I do not appreciate you saying and going across America saying I'm not. We got a phone call. Let's go to the phone call. Probably my coach.
Yeah, I was gonna say it's your old coach. Speedy, get in there.
That boy good.
Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from?
This is AC. I'm calling from Michigan.
What's up,
what
man?
What's up, Michigan?
AC? What you want to talk about, Pim?
What's happening, man? I was actually calling. Y'all was talking about earlier having sex in public.
Yeah. Mm. You get down like that?
He was like, I was having sex in public. Yeah. That's why I couldn't call earlier.
Check it out. So, the first time when I was 16.
16?
Yeah, y'all have Relay for Life out there?
Relay for Life?
Is that a marathon?
That sounds like something special you should not be having sex at.
It's a cancer walk.
Oh, man.
Oh, you wrong.
Wait, you fuck somebody with cancer? That is terrible.
She was in remission. Remission is dick.
So you was pumping that chemo in her, huh?
Got that stage 4 penis in your life.
She is healed.
Okay, so what happened?
You ain't got cancer in your pussy, bitch.
This is the cure right here.
Your pussy ain't affected.
Oh, Lord. Go ahead.
You just got it in the colon.
Not anymore.
This was my high school sweetheart.
Oh, you gonna put that? You gonna do that?
So check it out,
she dead.
And let him finish.
So, you know, I told my parents, you know, I'm going over to so-and-so house for the night because it's 24 hours. It's overnight in the park.
That'd be good.
What?
Oh, nigga, the Relay for Life is overnight in the park.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's overnight.
In Michigan?
In Michigan. In March, though.
Oh, okay, not Detroit, though. You can't be.
Oh, hell no.
Yeah.
In the suburbs. No
Several
way.
Marathon runners were robbed last night at the Run for Cancer.
A butt naked man with his penis out.
Apparently, you can fuck while you have cancer.
Right. So, the same young lady, 12 years later, I married.
Oh, damn. You had to after that. You made it 12 years.
Wait, you skipped a part. Now, what happened at the park during the 24 hours during the relay.
He's doing it in the park.
Oh, so we were just walking around, whatever, and then we decided we're going to, quote, unquote, go to sleep. So we ain't had no tent. I mean, black people don't have no tent. So we found the space behind the trees, laid out some blankets, and was laying there and doing what we was doing. And then she was like, "You got a condom?" I was like, "Shit, I got about 4 or 5. I got to."
You came to the cancer walk?
I had all kind of condoms.
At a cancer walk.
You came prepared.
Safety first.
Never know what could happen.
You didn't bring no plasma. You came.
I ain't going to get no cancer on my dick. I got condoms. Yeah.
I ain't got no bone marrow.
I ain't doing none of that.
I do have some platelets for you. You need some extra blood platelets.
Hey, so y'all had homeless sex in the park is basically what y'all just had.
You know, this is the worst story I've ever heard in my fucking life. Nigga, you went, you know, I'm from Michigan. You didn't name a city. You said Michigan. Like, we were supposed to narrow it down to a city. No, Detroit? No. I'm from Michigan.
Look at suburbs.
So, I was with a bitch at a cancer walk, and then we got married. And then Portis had to go, "What happened before that?" Oh, yeah.
Oh, we fucked.
So we fucked, and I had some condoms, and that was a joke.
Was you in the cancer walk? It just happened to walk by your butt naked ass. Like, oh, shit, they doing something here tonight.
Were you in the walk, and you said you had a second public story?
Oh, God.
No, not a second.
Yeah, on our honeymoon.
Oh, my God.
About sex on the beach. Hey. That's how we do it.
Were there people and kids?
Michigan ain't got no beaches?
Wait a minute. You didn't hear his joke. He said, wait a minute. You said, "We was on the beach. That's how we do it." What y'all think? Is that pretty good?
That's good.
That's a great story right there. I was on the beach and that's how we do it. You know,
black folks don't get no hotel rooms for their honeymoon. We just do it on the beach.
That's how we do it. We didn't have a tent.
We was in the Dominican Republic in Punta Cana.
There you go.
All right.
That's nice.
Oh, thank you for the phone call. I need you to do me a really big favor. In your kitchen, there's a knife drawer. Pull it out and fall on that motherfucker. All right. Thank you for the phone call.
Actually, Louis Dix is in there right now.
There you go.
Yeah, see, you should have led with that one.
Yeah, fuck the cancer walk. I mean, don't fuck the cancer walk. Well, you did. But.
Yeah, you fucked at the cancer walk.
This is my girlfriend, Kim Alicia.
Hey, his wife really loved him. Like, your honeymoon night, that's that one night to the women.
I forgot to ask him, did he meet the girl there at the walk?
That was his girlfriend.
This is a high school sweetheart.
High school sweetheart.
Oh, okay.
She's in the wheelchair.
323-293-3375. Apparently, we're talking about if you've had sex in public.
Where's the place you shouldn't have got it and you got some? Because he shouldn't have fucked at the cancer walk.
Got some white blood cells.
You can't fuck at the cancer walk. Some shit, you got, come on, you can't fuck at the cancer walk. Like, I fuck, yeah. I'll give you mine.
All get together.
Family reunion.
Kind of weather, mm-hmm. And we do the cancer walk.
It was family reunion at my grandmother's house, and I was fucking in the bathroom. I heard my grandma go, "Who in the goddamn bathroom?" And somebody said, "Speedy." I told the girl, I said, "How are we going to get out?" I said, "Just stay in the shower, and I walk out first." So I walk out, and my grandma, I said, "Don't go in yet. It ain't good."
Smell like Bedussi in here.
In about 35 minutes.
I remember this smell from 30 years ago. Your daddy used to have a bathroom smelling so great.
I shouldn't have
Who took a salty shit in here?
You did.
I shouldn't have did it.
Hey, but wait, is it a family reunion?
Yeah.
Third cousin on your auntie's. Wait, what?
No.
Three times removed.
It was my girl.
It don't count if it's third cousin or less.
No, it was my girl.
Right. I never met you before.
Mine is I was on the air here in L.A.
Wow.
And,
it just got real.
Can you speak a little slower,
please? Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
You were in public.
Yeah, she was on the radio.
I was on the air, and
this next
it was late. It was late night. It was.
Yeah, it was.
I think it was like the 2 to 6 a.m. shift. Mm-hmm.
The quiet storm.
That's why they be sounding so mellow at that time.
Yes, and my boyfriend came up.
Uh-huh. And he, no pun intended. He came up.
And what was crazy was I'm like right there where the mics are, the booth, the board, everything.
Okay.
So right after we finish, my boss walks by. I'm like, what the fuck is he doing here at 3 a.m?
He was listening.
Long time listener, first time watcher.
Oh, man, I would have been so busted. I mean, literally minutes after.
Could you get the mic out your ass, please?
Why is it hot in this booth?
Why does it smell like Medusa?
Yeah, outside is great.
No, where was the place you fucked? You shouldn't have, but.
Hey. Oh, shouldn't have fucked? Well, I mean, one time I was outside in the street.
What?
Yeah.
In the street?
In the street.
Like, street light.
Middle of the fucking street.
What?
How did that happen?
Well, because we were in the car, and we did in the car, and then, so, because she had people in the house, and so we couldn't really go in the house, and then, so on the way in between the car and the house, I was like, we have to do it again. Like, this is fun. And then, but it was late at night. It was like 4 a.m. There wasn't nobody out. I was looking around. Like,
bunch of pigeons
out.
Going, look here.
Yeah.
Tweet, tweet.
Squirrels like, hey, get it.
Squirrels like, get it, dude, get it.
So were you in the car or no?
In the car first.
Oh.
And then we were walking back, and I was like, I'm doing it again. And then it was just right there in the middle of the fucking street.
So you bent, what's his name?
What was
so you bent her over.
Bent her over.
In the middle of traffic?
It was 4 a.m. Nobody was out. And it was on a side street off of Main Street. So I could see other cars going by the Main Street, but I was just on the side street.
That's called an alley RT.
it was a prostitute. No, but it was fun. It was awesome. I was like, man, awesome. I got to do it outside more often.
What about you, Kente?
Man, since we go in there, I don't think they're listening. I had an ex whose parents were a preacher and first lady.
No, you
not in the church.
Not in the church,
but in the house. And there's an other room in the den watching TBN channel, and I was like, just shut up, I can see if they coming. It's a commercial, hurry up.
And you fucked by the TBS? And you wonder why your life fucked up.
I know, you know, I've been trying to make up for
that
ever since.
When I just said, was it in a church, why did Nikki Pam raise her finger?
Pam. In a church?
Pam, please.
Like,
say
Pam, no, I fucked in a church.
Pam's like, I have a story.
No, you can't
Pam,
fuck in a church.
What
Pam?
Happened?
Okay, it was me and my best friend, Nicole.
Wait, what?
My best friend. We were at church. I remember 54th Street in Western. I'll never forget.
That's still there.
And it was, I know, it is still there.
It's the golden
And we
pew.
Were back up behind the pulpit. Yes, we were. In the church. Nobody was there.
You and your best friend?
No, not me and her. And she had a guy, and I had a guy. She was down in the, like,
so the
on
pastor.
The benches.
She was between the
you
It actually
the
was a pastor's son.
Ooh. And a deacon boy, and she had a junior deacon
boy. I know
I
was such a heathen, but... You know,
what is this white shit on my Bible?
Everybody opening your Bible to Testicles 69:52.
Page 54 and 55 stuck. What the
she
fuck?
She said her friend was in between the pews.
That's on the ground.
When ye shall take the step.
You go to hell. You be like, I'm going to hit. No.
Well, you go
the
to church.
The devil going
to
be like, no, bitch, come on. You know where you're from.
Right after you finish, you can go right to the confessional. Be like, look here, you heard what I did.
Oh, we got a phone call. Somebody is fucking.
Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Oh,
they hung up?
Tone.
Yeah, rock hanging niggas up now. You ain't got your pants down. We ain't talking to you.
That was a strong hang up too. Click, clack, clack.
Fuck that a church, Pam. Yeah. I could never
Hallelujah.
Do that. I didn't fuck at a gang of places. I fucked on the freeway.
Welcome to our father of his touching
on
hands.
On the freeway.
What'd you say?
Our father of his touching hands church.
I fucked in the administrative building of the church. That doesn't really count.
Please don't take all
I feel
the
like
condoms.
That count.
All right, so anyway.
I'll take all the condoms out of the collection plate.
I fucked on the freeway. Me and this girl riding. She give me head. I'm like, fuck this, bitch. I need to. She said, what are we going to do? I pulled right on off the side of the freeway.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And I put her ass out the window. And then I saw somebody drive by. Beep, beep. I was, yeah.
That's me.
Thought for a minute you was going to have a Teddy Pendergrass story there. Like, we just kept driving. No. I'm sorry,
ran
too soon?
Into a tree.
Too soon?
We kept driving, and it was a man!
Now, I saw his unsung, and they didn't mention that.
Y'all know, you can't put that out.
They didn't mention that.
They,
and one
they
day, he just ended up in a wheelchair.
The woman, the transvestite that came out, that was in the accident,
mm-hmm.
I think she came out not too long ago.
Came
probably
out.
Probably have, but they didn't, they mentioned that it was a transvestite, but they didn't say, like, anybody knows his pants was around his leg.
Yeah.
This is Lisa. She's 6'2 with the hands of Dikembe Mutombo.
But there's a story going around that, I could be wrong on my facts here, but that was a cover up because Teddy Pendergrass was actually messing with some celebrity's wife, and that whole
in the back of the car,
right?
Was
like, go find a transvestite, put it in the back seat.
Dr. J's wife.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
What she was watching.
But the transvestite that came out, she said that she does not think that Teddy Pendergrass knew that she was what she was.
You was 6'5".
Well, wait, I think.
Nigga was 6'5".
No, because.
When they showed the picture, because they had a picture of him in Jet, back in the day, Jet.
Yeah.
And the picture in Jet, and you turn like this. I said, that's a dude.
Yeah.
Motherfucker, but I know a dude Richard, when I see a dude.
Or the picture of the transvestite.
Yeah. Yeah, he's a dude.
Richard Pryor said that he was fooling with the same one, and he said for 3 weeks he was gay. He said, this woman, man, was so fine. He's like, he found out and was like, fuck it. I got 2 more weeks in. Let's go and do what we do. Start stir crazy in a minute. Come on, let's do what we do. Figure out how we do this prison thing.
Well, like I said, I fucked on the freeway.
So the bitch was sucking my dick, right?
I tried.
Strong jaw muscles, bitch. Turns out the bitch is a man. Shit is crazy,
now,
right?
Have you ever did it on the elevator?
Yes.
I tried, but I was too scared.
Oh, no. You got to do it in your... I did it in my apartment building. Because you can't do it in a hotel because they got the alarm button. You just push the button on your in your apartment. They don't have the alarm. Shit stops. People's banging on the door. Hey, come on! I was in Westwood when I was at UCLA. I was like, hey, I'll be done in a minute.
And then you got to have that look.
Yeah.
Okay, we got the caller. Is the caller there? Okay. Yeah.
Oh.
Yes.
Teddy Pendergrass is on the line. I'm running.
So if you go to our website or go where listening.
You got what I need.
But yeah, that was I watched. I love Unsung, and I think we have somebody coming in a couple of days. Mm-hmm. One of the shows is from that helps with those Unsungs. The Unsungs are very good. Mm-hmm. Very good.
Yeah, I just did. I don't think I'm supposed to tell you.
Uh-oh. Don't mention it. Don't get in trouble.
Exclusive.
You're not supposed to release it until they say who the lineup is. But I did 2 already that's coming out in September.
Oh boy, where you were talking?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
No, what else would I do?
Sign language?
I hate you.
For the hearing impaired.
I hate you.
You know, I would like them to do an Unsung on E-40. That would be really, I really think he deserves it.
But he ain't really unsung, though.
Yes,
he is. E-40 is hot.
E-40's unsung.
Well, he's been at it a long time.
Give the definition of what unsung means.
It's when mainstream doesn't. When they're not so mainstream, but they meant so much to us.
I would say E-40 falls in that category. I mean,
I don't know if he's ready.
I don't think E-40's mainstream.
He's like as close as we gonna get to mainstream from Oakland. Mm-hmm. He's like, you know, we had
Too Short.
Hammer.
Too Short to me is more mainstream.
But then Too Short had an unsung.
Yeah, I'd say Too Short's more mainstream.
They did Too Short unsung.
Oh, they did?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, then E-40 should definitely be on.
Yeah, well, yeah. That's like when the Too Short did it, I was like, I know him. What are you doing? Everybody know Too Short.
But
it's on TV1. It ain't like it's on NBC. we still gonna be the ones who know about it.
Is it me or the commercials in between TV1? It's like 35 commercials.
Yes.
I'm like, God damn it.
We need advertising.
So can you get to the unsung?
Shows are really only like, if they're an hour long, they're really like 40 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah, but their show's got to be 30.
Yeah.
Yeah. For an hour.
Yeah.
So many. Pam, am I right or wrong?
It's 22 or 22:30 for a
For regular TV.
42
but,
to 44 for an hour.
Yeah, on cable though.
But yeah, for them, for TV1,
it's 13 minutes for an hour long episode.
Right when they tease you like, and back with Unsung. But before that, you could buy a razor blade for a penny.
The new McMuffin.
Yeah, they got plenty of McDonald's commercials on there.
I want to do an unsung on you.
Yeah.
Because, mm-hmm. Paul, you are you the shit. At the end of the day, you the shit.
Thank you, Speedy.
And I had to realize that after I left you, that all the shit I was dealing with, I was like, if Portis was here, you bitches be in check. Everybody in this room be in check.
That was his lead line every time he got mad. If Portis was in this bitch, none of this would be going down.
You motherfuckers would be, your life be fucked up. Because Pete knock you down.
You was like Kaiser Sosa everywhere he went. Oh, it is. When she show up, shit going down.
Kaiser Sosa.
I was like, I'm going to be on the show with Poe. This is like, for real?
I appreciated who you were and how you, you're just direct. And in life, you do need to have direct people to tell you exactly how things is. Even though everybody's like, just keep real with me. You don't really want motherfucker to keep real with you.
Nah.
Not really. Everybody liked to just sugarcoat it for me a little bit, tell me I'm doing well, and then tell me later on I fucked up.
Well, I'm glad Pete
stepped right up. You fucking up,
Speedy.
Nigga.
I'm glad you acknowledge it.
Yeah, because if I don't, it's written right here. You supposed to say that.
No. Make sure you say this about poetess.
But no, and for those people out there who don't know us, but you listen to the show, and some people, because you listen to us, you go, I know that motherfucker. Speedy ain't shit. We just fucked up. And fuck you niggas talking about my part. Fuck you. It's a nice part.
Where's the part at?
It's fuzzy.
Oh.
It fuzzed over?
It's coming back.
It's the lines over. Are fuzzy.
Got a smoggy part.
But thank you, Speedy. I appreciate
but,
it.
And I know motherfuckers go in because they think they know you and they go in on your on
Speedy's hair got a DUI? So your hair's been drinking.
Walk the straight hairline. I can't.
You say it's fuzzed over. But I'm doing this because I have to do this before we get in. But you're very good at what you do. And they should do it on Sunday.
Oh, well, thank you, contribute a lot. I appreciate that. Yeah. But when I do look back on my career, I've had a very blessed career. I may not be as famous as other people, which I'm cool with, but I've done a lot of fun, exciting things.
I didn't know you did poetry.
I did poetry. Well, I did an album. Oh. I was the first female rapper on Interscope. I mean,
you said poetry. I'm like, duh. What did you think she did?
I didn't know she did.
But you know poetry. What? I didn't go out and do spoken word. I was more of a writer.
I didn't know you talked with your mouth.
Her name is Talker.
More of a writer. I kept my poetry.
What are those sounds coming out of your mouth?
I didn't know you wrote with a pen. Her name is Pinetta.
Penetrous.
You know what I mean. Like, I didn't know you did poetry.
That's the blackest statement ever. I didn't know you did poetry.
Actually, recently, I just did, for somebody's birthday, I made a book with my poetry.
And I saw that. That's why I said that. I didn't know you did.
You're a writer? Yeah. Her name is Writeratress.
That don't mean nothing. You fast, Speedy.
What are those symbols you're putting on the paper?
Those are words, Speedy. Those are words. Writeratress.
Her name is Wordsmith.
Her name is Wordy Wordsmith.
And that explains a lot now.
Dumb motherfuckers. Y'all don't understand what the fuck I'm trying to say, man. I didn't know she did poetry like
stop saying, like every time you say it out loud, don't make it right. I didn't know she did poetry. Poetess.
Yeah, I just did a book for somebody's birthday with some of my
fuck
personal
the niggas
poetry
is laughing outside the camera. I didn't know.
Speedy.
But why did you think they called me poetess then?
But why do the words rhyme?
It's a poem, Speedy.
It was like haiku almost, but I didn't know you did haiku with this.
Because I just thought you were right. I just thought you would just lyrics.
And no rapper has ever done poetry before.
I think that's where it starts.
Wait a minute.
That's how rapping started.
Rap is poetry with a beat behind it? Who fucking knew? That shit is phenomenal. I fucking love you, Speedy, for that one. That made my week.
That was funny.
I thought you just rapped.
Thank you, Speedy. That was good.
Anyway.
A few more phone calls before we wrap up. 323-293-3375. We had, what's the name? What was our guest? Antonique?
Yeah. Apparently our back gate.
She was, she played Faith Evans on Notorious.
She was supposed to come in, but Speedy was not paying attention to his phone. She came and
I'm doing the show.
We're in a bunker, so you have to.
What are these symbols coming through on my phone?
I don't
want to
read that. I can't see. I ain't got my glasses.
I can't see.
I said I can't see.
Okay, cool. I don't have my glasses. I'm nice.
So hopefully we can get her back here on Friday. We do have some special guests, and
the picture looks nice.
On Friday we'll have some food, Speedy. So that should be exciting.
No,
touch that one.
I'm losing weight. I don't know whether you motherfuckers want to recognize it or not.
Oh, wait. I found it. It's over here. Here it is.
It's behind you now. It just moved to the back.
It migrated. To the back of your hips.
Hips. Grown man's without hips.
Nick got hips.
No, I've lost 20 pounds.
All right.
When?
Really?
Speedy?
I have lost 20.
Mm-mm. All right. Congratulations on losing 20.
The part took out that much?
The chunk of hair. You got some heavy ass hair, dog.
It's a tuft.
So putting that Jerry Curl juice in it.
Well, they say after you get married, you gain weight.
So you do the opposite.
He's been married twice.
So she can't cook.
I want one thing. They need to give a manual out on his marriage shit.
It's tough, huh?
Man.
That's why you lost the weight. You nervous?
What's so hard about it, Speedy?
Like being married, you find out like arguments. You don't get no pussy after arguing.
Yeah. And you can't just leave.
There's no winning in an argument for a man.
You fucking around trying to win the argument? You both be like, okay,
nigga,
dear.
I really was trying to win arguments and then was like, Kind of horny.
You can only do that when you got your own place to go to. Like, fuck you, I'm leaving.
And then you call another bitch that you didn't argue with. I didn't know that. I found that out.
You're married, you just go downstairs and watch TV.
I found all that shit out. And then you get ridiculed for, so you just gonna leave. You ain't gonna try to hug. But you said, get the fuck out.
We said we never go to bed mad.
You just curse me out. Man, this shit is, they don't give no man. And now nobody try to help you and tell you, hey, nigga, this is what you got. No.
You gotta talk to the elders.
Like, there's some shit I didn't know. Like if she come out and she got like a little see-through outfit, you can fuck. She come out of the bathroom with a scuba dive outfit on or the whole helmet on.
The snorkel oxygen tank.
It's no fucking for you. We got a phone call. Let's get this phone call. I'm venting right now.
No pussy for you.
Who? Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from?
Hi, this is Lucky. I wanted to say something to Speedy.
Hi, Mom.
Nigga, did your mama call in on cue?
Is it Lucky?
What do you want to say to Speedy, Mom?
Earlier, I posted on Facebook of a walrus doing exercise.
Exercising walrus?
I wanted to look at that post I put on Facebook showing the walrus was showing how to lose weight.
Your mama cloudy.
I got so many jokes. Poor this, I ain't gonna do
you
it.
That night, nigga, I'll kick you in your butt.
45 great ones at a woman.
Well, Mom, actually, Speedy is a manatee. Not necessarily a walrus, Mom, so it might have been his cousin.
He don't have the walrus.
Did he have a part in his hair?
Mom, your house is loud, so we're going to let you go.
Mama had to cook out. Bob.
Your mama did not call me with a meme and clown me. How your mama know to do a meme? This is the thing I don't understand.
Mama put the face make when he lose 20 pounds.
She posted on Facebook this morning.
A walrus on an exercise bike.
Doing exercises.
Doing Pilates.
Speedy after a new haircut. What?
Anyway.
Why does she think of you though, Speedy?
This is how I do with your mama. How? It's either Elmer Fudd or your mama. That's
what. Nigga, you ain't gonna talk about your mama. Nigga, you ain't gonna talk about my mama.
Is it Wednesday? Do I take the big six pill?
Bingo! I got bingo.
How old is Speedy? I put a meme up of you.
She didn't call it a meme. I got a meme. It's a meme.
I put it on Instagrams and the Facebooks and the Twitters. And
everything got an S on it.
And I had to tape it to a pigeon.
The social medias.
It's literally on my screen right now. I put scotch tape up. I change the picture every day. That's my
now,
profile.
Now, I know
picture.
You're not a walrus, Speedy, but that's all I could find. Apparently, manatees are endangered, and it's hard to find a picture of them.
Yeah, they don't stay still.
I went to the Googles, and the first thing that came up was the walruses.
I copy-pasted it.
Hey, your mama called it because I guess we on redown.
This is Lucky.
Tell your mama she ain't never got to say her name. I know it's her.
This is Lucky.
I made a meme.
Oh, you, Speedy.
Mama sounded like she used to run numbers back in the day. So you want to box that 3-5 to the 7.
Hey, but she is a gambler.
I knew it.
She's a gambler.
I knew it.
Thank you, Lord. Mm-hmm.
Anybody else can call in besides Mom?
Yeah, she got us on the flip-flop readout.
323.
As soon as the phone opened, it read out us.
3375.
It's Lucky.
She got us instead of medical alert.
Yeah. I've fallen and I can't get up, but tell Speedy.
But listen, while I'm on the ground, I made another meme of Speedy doing various exercises.
Before I go, tell my baby to call 911 for me.
I got him from the Jack LaLanne chart I have in my bedroom. The walrus is doing up downs and
up downs.
I wonder how'd your mama learn how to copy paste? This is the shit I want to figure out.
No, she shared a link of a manatee, a walrus doing exercise with its trainer.
So you knew about the joke.
Yeah.
Oh,
So y'all have a.
I saw the
y'all
post.
Y'all work together.
On I saw the post.
So you texted her and said,
"Mama, call it now."
I didn't have nothing to do with that.
No, that was funny.
He did it on.
This is lucky.
I made a meme
of you, Speed.
I got to go finish my potato salad now. We're having a cookout.
Got flies all in the kitchen. I don't know where these raisins come from.
Raisins.
Now, I am starting a Kickstarter campaign to raise money for more Speedy memes. So if you would like to donate or have an idea for various walrus positions that he might do.
Call in on one. That's my number.
That's my number one. I had the
next
first phone
one,
ever.
Speedy will be doing waybacks as a walrus.
Waybacks.
With his flippers up.
I can't fool with y'all.
I love it. Because your mother calls all in the same.
Ha, they're lucky. Look here. Where is Speedy?
Your mama, you know your mama loved me. You know that, right?
Yes, this has been the Star-Kissed Tuna joke of the day.
She sounded like she was on the Las Vegas turnaround bus.
Get off that phone. We got to get these tracks. We almost at the state line.
That was funny.
Next stop, everybody. We're going to stop. Everybody use the bathroom again. Shit.
We ain't never going to get to Vegas.
Next stop, Reno. Reno next stop.
They can't even get out of L.A.
Another stop for the bathroom. Shit.
Some Sister Johnson and clogged up the one on the bus again.
Oh, that's funny as hell.
I love your mama.
Lucky's great.
And I'm telling, because she plays dominoes.
She, of course she does.
She was trying to talk shit. And I kept going, don't do it, Speedy. She said something. I said, how about this, bitch? How about this? I went, shit, this poor his mama.
She said, it's okay, nigga. Just play your domino.
Play your game, motherfucker. Play your game.
Don't be no punk ass up in here.
Don't pull punches, Speedy.
It's kept going, this lucky.
I know you're lucky. It's your turn. You get to play. I know that goddamn.
I put up another meme of walrus is fucking Speedy. Don't get me started. I have other marine life on tap, I want you to know.
Wait till I get to the mermans.
So I Googled large seagoing species.
Somebody posted the picture.
Oh, fuck y'all.
That is Speedy. That's the same shirt he got on right now.
Oh, my God.
So, Rock, from here on out, I'm going to make up a cue card that's just going to say Lucky on it.
Just with Lucky.
Which she ain't got to say.
This is Lucky. Speedy.
She always start off like that.
This is Lucky.
And it looks like that's how she's sitting, too, with her arm back just a little bit.
Speedy.
Speedy.
Now, Speedy, you know, I found out various informations about Walt. You know they can live to be 70 years old?
How do you?
Oh, my God.
All right, we got another phone call.
We got another phone call. This is Lucky again.
Go ahead, Potus.
Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from?
My name is Lunel, and I'm calling from down the damn street.
Hey, Lunel!
Where the fuck are you at, baby?
I'm in my gown in my office.
That's a little more information than we needed, but okay.
You do the visual on that.
I will not.
Hi, Lunisi.
Hi, girl.
Come hang out with us, baby.
No. I have business, unlike you. I'm leaving tomorrow. I got things to do. I'm packing and washing, and all my assistants are off for the life. I have none. I got things to do.
For those who don't know, on the phone is a very funny, very talented Lunel from Oakland, Oaktown's own.
Oakland represent.
And you've been busy a lot, Lunel. You've been, you just did the Essence Festival, and you're on your way to Canada, is it?
Montreal Comedy Festival.
Oh, fantastic.
They never let me in before.
Uh-oh.
But I got the white boys behind me now. You know
there
what
you
that
go.
Means? So Innovative scooted me in. So
there you go.
So you said you're packing. How are you going to get that trailer home all the way through customs? Because it's a lot of clothes.
I know people.
It's a lot of clothes.
Unlike you, I'm friendly with
I'm just saying it's a lot of material.
I'm friendly with other nationalities, unlike you.
I mean, you have to get personal.
Well, Speedy's married to another.
Speedy's married to another.
Yeah, a white woman. Just
all the bitterness came out. A white woman. Yeah,
just
say
it.
It.
Just say it.
Just own it.
And you date a Latino.
No, that was two relationships ago.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm back on the brothers right now.
Right now.
Well,
right.
Hopefully you're not on them because then they couldn't breathe.
Shut up, Speedy.
All my men want me right there on them.
So oh, there you go.
Impossible.
You
fucking impossible.
Your weight class and I'll handle mine.
And still.
Still changing.
That's fine. Hey, listen, I will come down and fool with y'all, though. When I get a chance, because I want to say congratulations for Poetess having her studio up and running. Yes.
Thank you, Lou Nazy.
You know, a sister with her own studio these days, you know, if anybody deserves to have her own, it's you, girl, because you done paid the dues and paid the cost to be the boss, and so I'm very proud of you.
Now, Lunel, tell our fans how to follow you.
Well, listen, don't even look for me on that Periscope thing because I'm like a two-year-old on that. I don't know what to do. I don't know about the hearts. I don't know all that. I did see a really cute girl on there the other day that I'd like to hook somebody up with, but
I'm single.
Hey,
there's a guy paying $10,000 to be hooked up with a girl. Yes, he's giving away $10,000 if you can hook him up with a date that lasts 6 months.
Who wants that?
Some Chinese guy in Alabama.
That would be me. What's his name?
Well, I think he has a weight limit.
Wait, what was it? He has a website, Lunel.
I'm just saying.
Lunel, he has a website called dateren.com.
Wow, and he giving away $10,000? Yeah, $10,000.
Yeah,
up front.
No, you got to be with him for 6 months.
Yeah.
Well, I ain't got that kind of time. Yeah. You know. Hey, anybody looking to give away $10,000 to get a woman to be with him for 6 months? What would he pay if I married him? That's what I want.
Hey.
Yeah, you probably get everything.
My divorce is about to be final in 2 minutes, and I'm looking to, you know, look up on another opportunity like that fabulous one I had with that lousy motherfucker.
There you
anyway,
go.
Put a compliment in the disc.
Okay, but you can find me on my Instagram or Twitter, which is where I just posted like 70 pictures from the Essence Festival, and that's at Lunel, at L-U-E-N-E-L-L. Apparently, my Twitter game is weak. I really don't care about Twitter, but I think I'm supposed to.
Yeah.
But I have 149,000 Instagram followers I really care about.
Yeah.
Damn a lot, but I guess my Twitter game is lacking, so please follow me on Twitter, too, or Twatter, whatever it's called.
Twatter. You're on Twatter.
And then, yeah, Twatter. And then Jay Date and Christian Mingle. And then also, my website is heylunel.com, HeyLunel.com, where you could go on and order those fabulous T-shirts that you've been seeing Nick Cannon and other celebrities wearing around town. Speedy, we go up to a 4X.
Well, with that in mind, I definitely want to let you know you're an honoree at the Club Fluffies. We have your picture up at Club Fluffies. Yeah, so you
I
come
like
on in
it.
Anytime you want.
What do they do there? Because, you know, I'm opening up a strip club called Beefies.
Ooh.
You know? And you would be front row. I got your name already on a booth because all the chicks are going to be 165 and up. And we know.
Well, in my club, you have to. We weigh you. Anything over 300, you're in free. So you get in free twice. You can get in free and get out free.
You must just be wearing my boobs. Yeah,
they are very big. I must give you that.
I got cleavage today.
I've seen them one time.
What you doing in that debauchery, Pam? What you doing all up in there?
Pam is telling stories about doing? Fucking at a church.
Yeah.
Oh, not the old Alexander O'Neill story.
as a matter of fact, Lunel, let me ask you this. Before you go. So we asked, where was the most inappropriate place you ever had sex? What was the one place you knew you shouldn't have did it, but you did it?
In my kid's bed.
Oh.
So you broke the car bed?
On the Spider-Man. On the Spider-Man sheet.
To the NASCAR.
That's for boys. Little girls have Cinderella beds.
You
like
fucked
that.
On the Cinderella bed?
Lunel.
But the canopy came down and all kind of shit.
Told the baby, just don't sleep on the wet spot.
Lunel was like, Mom, what happened to my bed? I said, there's an earthquake.
It was an earthquake and a tidal wave.
School. I thought they would have talked about it.
Stop, drop, and roll.
Yeah, daddy will fix it, though.
Look, your new daddy will fix it.
It wasn't daddy that I was in the bed with. That was your Uncle Daddy.
Thank you for the phone call, baby.
Yeah,
thank
you. You guys keep on keeping on.
Have fun in Montreal, okay? Yeah.
Thank you.
Get your TV show. Fuck the dumb shit.
For real.
And I'll be your husband.
No, widescreen. We need to make a movie.
Widescreen.
All right, Lunel.
Thank you, Lunezy.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, Lunel.
She's super.
Town business.
I did Montreal.
She from the town.
Yeah, I did Montreal.
She sure is. She used to Soul Beat back in the day.
Yeah, I ain't did Montreal yet. Yeah, I ain't got enough white people on my team yet. My name Kente.
What about you, RT?
No, I haven't done Montreal yet either.
Is that the big thing for comedy?
Yeah, Montreal's
comedians?
Big.
That's where you can get a show.
Mm-hmm.
And back in the day, if you're a black comic or a white comic to hang with brothers.
Hey, no offense.
If you go, you pretty much was going to get a show because just being there, something was going to happen for you.
Mm.
The only thing was when I went.
Nothing happened for you?
He said being there. not driving by. Got to be inside is what he was saying.
Let's move on. What I was going to say is the only problem I had with it is that when you perform and there's a big tower and all the agents and managers are in those towers, and it almost looked like slavery, because you would come up, do your thing, and if you were funny, they would, you know, get at you. But all these people were staring at you and pretty much judging you on everything, and it just felt kind of weird. It felt weird to me.
It wasn't like a show. It was like a showcase.
But it was like a show. But there was a big tower in the middle, and in that tower were all the, or and I won't say a tower, but it was levels.
And when you went up, they had like an auctioneer. Got 50, got a 55, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70.
Who's got a dick joke? Got a dick joke? Who's
got a dick joke?
Pussy joke? Got a pussy joke?
Butt naked black joke. Sold to. I'm sorry, Speedy. I see it's still raw for him. But leave it alone.
Still hurts.
Still real.
No lube in Montreal. No lube. Stick it right in.
It's been a great show.
Yeah, I have fun. It's therapy.
Let me see the walrus picking in.
The walrus pick.
This is lucky.
Now they superimposing faces on it, so I don't know if that's
not my faces.
No.
I can't see it out of my glasses on. I can't see. That's you
cold.
Motherfuckers are
I
wrong.
I love that crunch. It's a crunch.
Yeah.
Me and mama gonna make a meme. My mama can't even. I called my mother on the phone.
I didn't know what the phone was doing. I said, Mama, answer. Just flip it open.
Flip it? Wait, who does that?
I heard it making noises.
I picked it up, put it to my ear, and never stopped ringing.
Lucky I love you. And I'll be in Oakland.
When?
On the third. Well, I'll be up north at
Tommy T's.
No. We're still working on it.
Oh, we're still working on it.
But on Ask Applin or shit.
Ooh, what?
Appleton.
What?
That's, nowhere near Oakland.
Yeah, I've never heard of that.
Yeah.
Let me finish, motherfuckers.
Spit it out.
Apple Valley.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah. That's nowhere.
For the Jazz Festival.
Oh, that's nice.
I'm hosting that July 31st.
Nice.
And I'll be there from
Where's
Friday.
Where's that by, what, Napa? Where's
Napa
that?
Valley, I'm sorry.
Napa
yeah,
Valley?
I'm about to say Apple Valley. I have Apple yet Valley. To find that shit.
So you Napa.
Oh, I want to go to that.
Oh, just let it slide, though. She's like, Apple Valley, okay.
I know where that is. Like, not.
That ain't adjacent to shit in Oakland.
Yes, I'm sorry. Napa Valley.
Yeah.
So I'll be there for the Napa Valley Jazz Festival, July 31st. I'll be hosting. There's a comedy show that Saturday, or Friday, and then the Jazz Festival.
Well, nice. Come on down there.
Yeah,
moms will come down.
No, I don't hate
your mom. They got wine tasting.
Speedy is lucky.
And Speedy's part will be opening for him. So if you guys want to come out to the show.
Oh, my.
I want to shout out DJ Twin. He's going to, let's see, what you text me here.
She went jail, mom.
You can check out DJ Twin at Mo Betta Monday nights at the Hollywood Improv.
There we go, yep.
Yeah.
For guest list, you can call 323-769-5144, and you can also follow DJ Twin on LA's, that's LAS, own DJ Twin with two N's.
That is
also, Isaiah,
our
wannabe hired.
Toop is back. Toop is actually shadowing Rock today so he can learn how to run.
Oh, that's
everything.
Why his pants are down.
He's got his.
oh, what that means, Speedy.
Toop's going for the PM Dawn.
I think you should read this. I can't read your writing.
He's in a new room. AM Dawn.
Toop looks like he a cornerback for the University of Miami over there with that hair. And you have your scholarship already?
Also, we will give a shout out to
this haircut comes with gold teeth.
Give a shout out to Marie LaMail, Platinum Star PR.
Yeah, she gets our guests.
She gets all our guests, all our hot guest stars.
We had a guest, but she couldn't come.
Next time we're going to give her to tell the guests to buzz somebody other than Speedy so they can actually get inside.
We'll yes, Marie, number. Give have them call me because yeah. Speedy's
Speedy looking. Dumb. Who, I don't recognize
I'll
this number.
I'll just play it.
Shout out to, is it Creative LaBiz?
My phone's making noises.
Someone's calling, Speedy.
My nephew wrote this, and nigga, shit. Nigga, write like a 3-year-old.
No, you just runs can't in the family. Read, Speedy.
He's going to be, they're going to be at the, I don't know.
I can't read.
They're going to be opening for Lil Debbie.
To come out here and translate this for your uncle.
Oh, yeah, it is chicken scratch. That looked like a prescription. You need 3 grams of Prozac. No. Open it for Little Debbie's Donuts.
That looks like a Michael J. Fox autograph.
We got to show... we got to show this 24th at Las Palmas in Hollywood. Open up for Little Debbie. So tickets 15, everybody get there. Show starts around like 8 o'clock.
Wait a minute, you talking about the cream puff?
That's what I'm saying. They're gonna give out donuts.
No, it's a rapper. She's a rapper.
She named herself after the cream puff.
She better be big. She can't be skinny named Lil Debbie. Like, you ain't even trying.
When is this? It's on the 24th?
The 24th of this month, July, at Las Palmas in Hollywood.
Nice.
And you spill.
And what are you doing?
I'm the engineer. So I just go and just listen to my music and
you spill.
Nice.
LOOS.
Thank you, too.
PALL.
No, that's an at symbol. Yeah. It's at Los Palmas.
I thought it was Capomas.
You're like, you're going to be at Carlos Palmas' house.
It's been a great show.
Yeah, you can find me on Twitter and Instagram at OG Poetess.
Oh, your sound effect.
And like our page, Morris Media Studios on Facebook and The Poetess on Facebook.
Yeah, if you want a show.
Yeah, if you want a show, hit us up at contact@morrismediastudios.com. We are building the programming lineup here where you can stream audio and video. We also do voiceovers here. If you want to do YouTube videos, we're setting up the green screen and we have lighting kit. So we have a bunch of media services in addition to just internet radio. So hit us up, contact@morrismediastudios.com. We officially launch in August, though. Speedy put a gun to my head and made me do this show.
No, I took you a week.
Starting last.
That's a gun to a head. Now,
exactly.
It's my medicine.
I had you do all that because the other side of that, people who want a show, don't come in here with the bullshit.
Yeah.
Because Poetess will be Poetess. And she'll be like, that ain't going to work. Thank you. And you'll be out the door going, no, I want to do a show about fishing. And nothing.
Well, now what the difference is, it's like, it's my company and I really have to run a business. This shit ain't free. These lights, this electricity, this building. We have 1,800 square feet here. We have a conference room, a kitchen, you know. So this shit costs money. So we got to make it work for us if you guys want to continue to
have
get
a good
this
idea.
Uncensored comedy shows support. If we're selling t-shirts or if you like the show, you know.
Buy something, bitch. You can hit me up on Speedy is Funny. That's Speedy IZ Funny on everything. And on Facebook is Comedian Speedy. And the website is speedyandfriends.net. That's Speedy, the letter N, .net. And buy a tee. I got a whole garage full of
niggas. Shucky Ducky shirt.
So I go in the garage, and the kids that took the t-shirts and laid them on the fucking ground playing marbles.
So if
they stopped the marbles, Daddy.
It's perfect.
So if you want an oil-stained t-shirt, call Speedy.
Niggas is playing marbles on the motherfucking tee. Buy the t-shirt.
They like, Daddy, they've been here for 3 years. What are we supposed to do with them?
Now they're apparently half off. They're
can't
half
even get
off,
to my bicycle no more.
And we will be in Palm Springs next weekend. I'm going to try to get everybody there. Now everybody got their hand raised. They want to go. Pam want to go. You know what that means, Pam.
Oh, shit.
Gonna do something.
Time to pay a visit to the church.
Get down on these pews.
Get down on these motherfucking pews.
Pew, 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 pew.
And read the scripture in your mouth.
In your mouth.
You can look me up on Instagram and Twitter at RT Steck or at RT Comedy and RT Steck Comedy on Facebook and all that good stuff. So please be looking out for me. Big things in the future.
All right.
Yeah, and I'm on Instagram and Twitter, Kentageous, KenteGious. Kente Scott on Facebook. Kentageous Comedy is my fan page. And I also got a comedy boot camp coming up in L.A. If you're in L.A., you want to try and do comedy or you're aspiring to do comedy, you need somebody to punch up your jokes, July 14th, holler at your boy.
You want to be a comedian.
Or if you want to be a comedian, yes.
And Nikki Pam on Twitter and IG, 2Ks, N-I-K-K-I-P-A-M.
Does your hair want to say what
Nikki
Pam?
Fuck you.
I'm just saying you have it stitched in there. They want to say something. Right?
We've been trying to talk all show.
You know what? Nikki Pam has actually very nice,
beautiful
long
hair.
Long hair.
It's a good shit, too.
She only wears the weaves to give it, what is it, depth or fullness.
Give it the bullshit.
But her hair is actually really that long.
It's very pretty.
That's the woman reason. I just give it to give it some flavor, some fluff.
Now we're going
to
tell you the man reason. Why do you do that? I don't want to comb it.
Yeah, exactly.
And I heard the curtains match the carpet.
With that in thought. Till we'll be here Friday. We have special guests here Friday.
Yes.
Shout out to Linnell for calling in. We do appreciate
Thank
you calling
Linnell.
In.
Yes.
And, the
and
guests
all of you
yesterday.
For logging in and yes. supporting the show. We
and
appreciate it.
And talking
it.
Shit about us.
Thank you. Peace.
Peace.